Yes, good afternoon, all of you. So I hope you have revised and come, okay, which I every day expect from you. And have you solved the assignments? Okay. Both the assignments. Assignment one was to cross-check your answers, okay, and the other one was, yes, to solve the questions and then cross-check the answers. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can meet for those questions after the class also, or otherwise in the end of the session. Okay, so today we are going to begin the legislature. Okay. We have done with the fundamental rights, directive principles, fundamental duties, preamble, and union and state, or state and union territories, state reorganization. Okay, so these were the basically the introductory aspects of constitution. Although fundamental to the constitution only, but today we are going to start the most important. Like when we say state is about the three organs of the state, that is the legislature, executive and the judiciary. So we are going to begin today with the legislature, then we will go to the executive. Okay, there is a reason why I am starting first with the legislature. Okay, because for this class we required to also see, okay, where the maximum number of questions are coming. Apart from that, within the executive also, I'm going to start directly first with the legislative procedure, budget, and etc. And then tomorrow we can do those formal rituals, how to elect the person and what is the qualification, disqualification, okay. That we can do hurriedly, but this is the most important part. If you see again 5-10 years question paper, time and again questions is asked on this particular topic, that is about the parliament, procedures of parliament, dynamics, okay, so on and so forth. So we will do other parts also. I am not omitting that part, but the thing is that I would like you to read back at home those formal parts like MPs and MLAs, disqualification and qualification, so that we can just push through those things hurriedly from the in the class. Okay, so that maximum focus is given on the core part. So legislature, in fact, in case of a legislature, there are both the aspects. Obviously, that is related to state legislature and central or the parliament and the state legislature. Parliament and the state legislature. Let's go. Now, as a part of introduction, we are going to see, okay, because the question I again ask on the theoretical basis also. So we will first see the concept that is about the parliamentary form versus presidential form. Parliamentary form of government versus presidential form. Presidential form of government. Presidential form of government. Marker zara theek wala leke aao yaar. So parliamentary form and presidential form. Now see, the thing is that while making the comparison, okay, there are different terms when we will see in the concepts. Basically in case of center-state relations we are going to see. So when we say about the federal and union territory, so federal has to be compared with the unitary form of government, unitary form. Republican form of government has to be compared with monarchical form of government. Okay, so you should very particular in regarding what is to be compared with what. Okay, in this case, what do you compare? What is the basis of comparison here? What's the basis of comparison? Yes, distribution of power is basis of comparison, that whether it is divided between the center and the state, or states are merely the appendages of the union. Okay, so that is the difference for the classification. Here, what is the basis for the division? Yes, basically it is a head of the state. Okay, whether the head of the state is a hereditary, or whether the head of the state is, yes, elected. Here the basis is what? Okay, here the basis is the three organs and their interrelationship. That is the executive. As there is a principle called as separation of power. Separation of power. There was a person called Montesquieu who has given this theory. Montesquieu. Sometimes used as a synonymous with the separation of power. Okay. Montesquieu, a French philosopher or a French scholar who had discussed about the theory of separation of power. So theory of separation of power, that is executive, legislative powers and judiciary. So these are the three. So when the law is there, they implement the law or execute the law, they make the law and they adjudicate the law, that is through the judicial review. So there is a separation of power exists. So tell me where the separation of power exists between the two of them. No, I am just asking this much. Okay, separation of power is a feature of parliamentary form of government and presidential form of government. Presidential. I'm just asking this much. Okay, separation of power is a feature of parliamentary form of government, presidential form of government, both and none. It's a both, okay. Do not see that it's just a feature of presidential form, since we are comparing it. Separation of power exists in both. What is important is how strong is the separation, what is the relationship between the different organs, okay, which has given the different power. So if you see this execution of the law, law-making power and adjudication of power. So in India also we will see in case of a presidential form, there will be a doctrine of separation of power. But yes, then beyond that, then how is the relationship between the three organs? That determines whether it is a presidential form. So per se, the mere separation of power, you cannot use as a point of difference between the two. Okay, so you have to go into seeing the relationship between the three. Now coming to the first, that is how is the relationship between the three organs of the government in case of the parliamentary form. Okay, in case of parliamentary form of government. Now the most important, although the Lakshmikant would mention 5-6 points of parliamentary form, but all are not correct. Okay, in case of means, you may write all those points. You will not go wrong. Okay, say for example, one of the thing it mentions, that is a political homogeneity. Okay, so some of the things which are conditional in nature, they are not characteristic feature, they are not exclusive. Okay, some may, in some parliamentary form it may occur, it may not occur. Okay, so there are certain conditional features the Lakshmikant mentioned. But when we see the parliamentary form of government, what is the most important thing is not about whether there are two executives. Okay, what is the most important is about collective responsibility. Okay, so the hallmark of parliamentary form of government, the first character feature is, that is collective responsibility. This is the single most point which differentiate it from the presidential form of government. So what is a collective responsibility? That is executives are responsible to the legislature. Executives are responsible to the legislature. Now, when we say executives are responsible, in case of parliamentary form of government, there is a council of minister headed by prime minister. Okay, these are responsible to the legislature. Legislature in general and yes, Lok Sabha in particular. Lok Sabha in particular. Now here if you see, the legislature, here judiciary we will keep separately, and executive. These executives are drawn out of the legislature only. Like in case of India, first there will be election of MP, and from the election of MP there will be Council of Minister and Prime Minister. So what here is happening, there is no executive is not completely separate. Although the principle of separation of power is there, but executives are made responsible to the legislature. Now, when we use the term the collective responsibility or they are responsible, what does it mean? What does it mean, responsible? Harm, okay. They swim and sing together. What does it mean? Yes, so there are two things, okay. In fact, yes. So whatever the executives will take the decision, that can be scrutinized. Okay, all the acts of omission and commission can be scrutinized by the legislature by a variety of the ways, like from the question hour, motions, adjournment motion, censor motion. There are different tools through which the legislature is making the executives accountable. That is one thing. So for the act of omission and commission. And second, the most important thing is they can, in fact, the tenure of this depends upon the majority they enjoy on the floor of the house. So in fact, if they lose the majority, that there will be a no confidence motion and the executive can be removed, unseated completely. Okay. So the tenure of the executive directly depends upon the majority that they enjoy on the floor of the house. Okay. So there are two things when we see about the responsibility. For their every act of omission and commission, they are answerable to the legislature. It means that legislature, through different mechanisms, through the question hour and motions and resolution, etc., they can make their acts and omissions accountable to the floor of the house. And second is, their very existence depend upon the majority they enjoy. Okay, so it is in the form of two. That is, one is the accountability in the form of the question answer, and second is in the form of no confidence motion. So this is called as responsibility. When we use the word collective responsibility, it means that not a single individual minister is responsible. Okay, it's the Council of Minister in collectivity. In collectivity, that is the whole executive in collectivity responsible for the lower house. Are you understanding? So this is the hallmark, or you can say that the most important point of parliamentary form of government. The rest of the characteristics are flowing from this. Okay, that is a de jure and this thing. Those things also we are going to see. But remember, this is now in case of here, we will compare this. What is the responsibility simultaneously? There is no collective responsibility. Here, see the, it does not mean now collective responsible does not mean that there is no separation. Separation exists, but there is a responsibility. Here, what happens? Executive is completely separated from legislature. Okay, judiciary to separate hai, but there is no relation whatsoever in between the two. So here, if you take the case of US government, this President Obama is not a part of legislature. He is not a part of legislature. He is independent. He is not answerable to the lower house, although in very special circumstances, he can be impeached by legislature, but that is not. See, this impeachment you cannot compare with the no confidence motion, because no confidence motion, that you need to have a majority. Majority as a criteria. So even if the President Obama don't have even a single member from the Democratic Party, still he can continue to remain a president as long as there is a no charges of treason on him. Treason, that is for the, say for example, violation of constitution. So the number in the legislature has nothing to do with the existence of executive in case of presidential form. Are you understanding? So neither he can be removed nor he can be made accountable. That is a complete separation of power. There is a complete separation of power where here the responsibility is being focused. Understood this part? So second thing is now in the collective response. Now, if you see this after the responsibility, that here there is a responsibility to the house. There is no responsibility, they functions independent of each other. Second thing is the point with respect to the executive. This is the second most important point. What about the executive? Who are the executive here and who are the executive in case of presidential form of government? Here the executives are two. That is generally we call dual executive. Okay, dual executive, or generally we call it as a nominal executive and real executive. Nominal executive and real executive. So nominal executive is president, okay, and real executive is prime minister or council of minister headed by prime minister. See, the real executive is not just prime minister, Okay, generally we tend to say it as a prime minister, okay, but it is a multi-executive, multi-member executive. The whole term is used for the Council of Ministers. He is the only first among equal. Okay, so Council of Ministers are also executive in that regard. This is generally we use the term de jure and de facto. Okay, so de facto is a real and de jure is legally. Okay, legal or on paper, by rule, by law, by rule, by law. Okay, by paper, who is? By paper, the executive is president. Okay, and in reality, de facto means factual. In reality, that is a prime minister. Okay, Council of Ministers headed by Prime Minister. Also, you should remember these two terms. Obviously, de jure, de facto, nominal and real, and then head of state and head of government. Who is the head of state? It's the president. Okay, head of the state is a president, and head of the government is, yes, Prime Minister. So, this differentiation we see in case of parliamentary form of government. We do not see. We will come to that presidential form of government. So, executive is two, okay, that is a nominal and the real. All the acts of the government of India are carried out under the name of president. Even if the prime minister is doing everything under the name of president, that's why we call under the name hai, isiliye usko de jure bolte. Legally he is, although the decision is taken by the prime minister. One of the important point that also differentiate this particular point, why we should call him, because the president will act as per the aid and advice of Council of Ministers headed by Prime Minister, and whose advice will be binding upon him. So he is just a sort of a rubber stamp. Okay, we will see in detail about it, what are the discretionary powers and etc. if at all there. But for all practical reasons, he is just a ceremonial head, okay, nominal head, titular head, okay, just only a title. It's a ceremonial title. So a president has to work as per the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers and the Prime Minister. So understood, so two important aspects here for the parliamentary form of government. One is the collective responsibility. Second is the executive, that is a nominal executive and the titular executive and the real executive. Now here we will see how is the executive. Executive is, there is only one. That is, there is no difference like this, nominal and real. Okay, he is real only. He is a de facto as well as de jure. So President Obama is both. Okay, so he is a de facto also, and he is a real executive. So jo head of the state, in fact, how do you call it here? That is a head of state. Head of state is real executive. Here, what it is, head of state is, yes, that is a nominal executive. In fact, is America and in case of India, what is the common feature of head of the state? What is the common feature of head of the state for the America and for India? Yes, republic. Okay, the word republic, if it is, it should not be mixed with parliamentary and presidential form. Okay, the commonality between the two is both are republic. America is also republic and India is also republic, because head of the states are elected. It has nothing to do with whether our head is nominal or not. It has nothing to do with he is a rubber stamp or not and he is a real. Republic has nothing to do with that, with the power of president. It has to do with how he has been, whether he is elected or whether it is a hereditary in nature. Understood this point? Okay, so these are the two points. Moving further, okay, moving further, let us understand what are the other subsidiary points. Subsidiary points, third, again it is flowing from this. Since now the president is only a nominal and prime minister is very important, it is also called as prime ministerial form of government, or prime minister and core committee of Council of Ministers is a cabinet, so it is also called as cabinet form of government. And since this particular all parliamentary form originated in the Britain, okay, and the Britain's parliament is located in the Westminster, so it is also called as Westministerial. So the alternative names are prime ministerial form of government or cabinet form of government or West ministerial form of government. It's the one and the same. This reflects the real location of the executive power. This reflects the real location of executive power. So do not get confused, it's the one and the same. Okay. Next is about, the fourth is about what they call as a dual membership. But there is again a caveat. You cannot see that this is a very loosely used word. When we say that dual membership, now here the executive are drawn out of the legislature in India. So therefore, the executive is also a member of legislature because he is drawn out of the legislature. So dual membership, so whoever is an executive, he is also a member of legislature. But there is a catch here. What is the catch? What is the catch here? There can be possibility, yes, executive can be a, he can be a minister, okay, without being a member of legislature for 6 months. Okay, for 6 months in India, there is a provision that you can become a member, okay, without even not being a part of legislature. So within the 6 months, he can go for the election. So first he can become a minister also, and then he can go for the election within the 6 months. So this statement is not absolutely correct. Okay, absolutely correct if you see the dual membership, that if I make a statement that executive, no member can become a minister without he being a part of legislature. Is the statement right or wrong? It's wrong. Okay, constitutionally, there is a provision that you can become a minister, okay, without being a part of legislature for 6 months. Understood? So that's a provision you should remember. Otherwise, there is a, if you leave that one exception aside, then all the executives are the part of legislature. Now, what will be the point there? Okay, that is called as presidential form and dual membership. There is no, because executive is completely separated. Now, there is one more thing here, how the executives are appointed. Here, the executives are appointed, first of all, Prime Minister, how he is appointed. First of all, Prime Minister. So, whoever that is a majority party in the lower house, okay, the leader of the majority party, the leader of majority party is appointed as a Prime Minister, okay? And rest of the, yes, ministers are appointed by, again by the President only, but on the advice of Prime Minister. Do not say that he is appointed by Prime Minister. He is not appointed by Prime Minister. They are appointed by President only, because the oath is, oath and affirmation is given by the President. So they are appointed by the President, but on the advice of Prime Minister. But here again, one more thing, that Prime Minister has to choose the people from the legislature. By and large, they have to choose the people. Why I'm saying by and large? Because 6 months, that, okay, exception. But otherwise, he has a limited choice. He has to pick up the people from the slot of legislature. Are you understanding? So how the executives are being elected here in case of that is a parliamentary form of government, that is, the President has a limited choice, that he will go into the lower house and he will see that who is enjoying the majority. He will choose the member as a Prime Minister and then rest of the member as suggested by the Prime Minister as a ministers. In case of executives there, now President get elected directly. So he is not appointed as such by anyone. He get elected by the people. And second is, how the rest of the cabinet are getting elected, it is completely for the President to determine what his cabinet will constitute of. His cabinet not necessarily will go come through the election. Okay, not necessarily. Nahi hi aate hain. Okay, there is no, nothing like that. They have to come through the election. So the people are only electing the President. Okay, so the President has a lot of scope in picking up the good people, or the, you can say that for that matter, yes, the specialist also in different field, so that he can pick up those things. Here the Prime Minister's scope is limited, that he has to select it from the legislature. So therefore, many a times it happens that in case of parliamentary form of government, it is generally termed as rule of amateurs. Amateurs because Yes, we can say that. Matlab, you can see the current composition, Irani, Afghani, vagera, vagera. Theek hai. So the immature people can get the chance here. There also there is a possibility of getting the chance, provided that the precedence is insane. Okay, he also can choose a person from class 10 or class 7 also. But there is a scope at least, even if a person is a scientist, even if a person is an engineer, doctor, agricultural specialist, researcher, he can go for it, even if that person is not a part of legislature. So there is a lot of scope. Okay, that's why they say that one of the advantage of presidential form of government is that you can have your cabinet, a specialist cabinet. Okay, a specialist cabinet you can have. But it does not mean that here you can see this point of difference is a very subjective, and it depends upon what kind of the composition. You cannot make this as a technical point. This is a rule of amateur versus rule of specialist. Your answer is wrong. Okay. As the Lakshmikant gives a rule of amateurs in the characteristics. So do not mug it up as a parliamentary form of government 1, 2, 3, 4 and then rule of amateurs. No, it can be the different way. If you see the cabinet of Canada, which form of government is there in case of Canada? Parliamentary form. Okay. The new guy there. Yes. So if you see the cabinet, okay, it is one of the best cabinet that any country can have. Okay. So it depends upon if your composition of parliament is very good, then obviously you will get the chance. And if you see, except the America, rest of the presidential form of government, not many times the specialists are being picked up. Most of the times it gives the scope for nepotism. Okay, matlab ek hi family ke tin tin char char president hai, fir cabinet bhi unhi ka hai, sab kuch unhi ka hai. So it becomes a despotic government. Are you understanding? There are good points of that, good points of this also. So the rule of amateur and these things is a very conditional. Okay, it's not a characteristics feature. You can say that, yes, it is a characteristic feature of parliamentary form. Understood this point? The next is about, they say about the majority rule. Okay, majority rule, matlab. This actually is not a separate point. This point can be related with this, no confidence motion. Majority rule means, you can be an executive as well as you enjoy the majority on the legislature. Okay, you can be executive only till that point, till the time you enjoy the majority. Here there cannot be the word called as majority rule, because the executive is completely independent of his strength in the legislature. Understanding? Is there anyone who has not understood so far what has been discussed? Okay, these are the characteristic features: collective responsibility, dual, this thing, this is called as the prime minister or cabinet form, dual membership with one exception, then rest of the things that we have discussed. Is that fine? Yes? Minister responsible? Yes, and parliament in particular, sorry, Lok Sabha in particular and legislature in general. Yes. See, the thing is that when we say that Council of Minister, headed by Prime Minister, there is a collective responsibility to the legislature in general and Lok Sabha in particular. Now, see, the thing is that technically speaking, when we say collective responsibility and they should enjoy the majority, when we say enjoy the majority, you require a majority in the Lok Sabha only, not in Rajya Sabha. Think of this. Current government, they do not enjoy the majority in the Rajya Sabha. So it's only the majority in the Lok Sabha that counts, and it's only in the Lok Sabha that you can go for the no confidence motion. Are you understanding? But why then why you are using the word in general also? It is used because for rest of the accountability, like question hour, motions, resolutions and etc., all other things except the censor motion and the adjournment motion, you can carry out those motion in case of Rajya Sabha also, so as to make them accountable. Okay, so question hours and resolutions and motions minus this no confidence motion can be moved. Okay, so in that way they are responsible. It is not something like that just because no confidence motion, they are not at all responsible to Rajya Sabha. Okay, they are responsible, but for removal or for the majority, it is the Lok Sabha that is important. Another important point, since you have mentioned that is about Council of Minister responsible to the legislature in general and Lok Sabha in particular. There is one more thing. the Council of Minister is collectively responsible to the Lok Sabha and individually responsible to not Parliament, President. Okay, individually. Now try and understand what does it mean. Ye to samajh mein aa gaya, collectively responsible. Collectively responsible means if the no confidence motion is passed, the whole government gets sacked. Okay, the whole government gets removed. But many a times we see that only one minister is getting removed. Now what is this mean? This means that he is also responsible to the president individually. It means that in any case, say for example, there are certain allegations on him. So a prime minister can suggest the president to remove him, single minister. Okay, that has not to be passed by the, in case of legislature. Are you understanding? So council of, that is a less significant point, but yes, that is a, ministers are collectively responsible. So that is the word sink and swim together, kis mein aa jayega? Collective mein aa jayega. Okay, sink and swim together. Swim is that if they are there and floating, they will be floating in collectivity. If they will sink down, they will sink down in collectivity. That is through the collective responsibility. Individual responsibility, one can, yes, go. Ek ka matlab clean bold ho sakta hai because he is individually responsible. Understood these points? Okay, these are the very basic concepts of parliamentary form and the presidential form. So while reading, just because statement is correct, it does not mean that is an answer for the what has been asked. Many a times UPSC play this trap. Okay, they will ask the question and the answer is in one or two statements. They will give the four statements. Two statements are correct, but they are irrelevant to the question. Two statements are correct, but they are irrelevant to the question. So you should mind that the concept has to be related with one or two or whatever the number of statements that are there. Understood this point? Okay. So generic point should not be taken into account. Whenever we will solve the multiple choice questions, again we will see how to go about it. Shall we proceed now? Okay. So we'll start with the parliament now. And see, this election of parliament and etc. we are going to see later, okay? Jo bhi member of qualification hai, how they are getting elected, etc. That we will see tomorrow. We will start with the most important function of parliament, that is lawmaking, okay? The most important function of parliament is lawmaking. Lawmaking. Now, very basic. All of you must be. That is law broadly, very broadly. There is a Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So, and then there is a president. So, when it first it start as a bill and then it end as a act or a law. So, it passes through the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. This can be house number one or house number two. This can be house number one and house number two. So bill can originate in different house. Bill will pass through this house. Bill will pass through this house. And president will give the assent. Assent to the bill. So a bill becomes an act when it passes through the two houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. And when it is given a president assent. Okay, very basic thing. So we are going to see that how it is being passed through the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Are you understanding? So bill and act. Now this bill, there are different procedure for different bills. So depending upon that, there are different classification of the bill. Because procedure for everything is not same, although the majority of the procedure is same, but there are certain changes also. So first, as a point of preliminary understanding, we will see what are the different types of bills. Okay, different types of bills. These different types of bills can be classified in two ways. Types of bills. This can be classified in two ways. One classification is depending on who is bringing the bill in the house. This classification is depending upon who is bringing the bill in house. Yes, what is the classification here? Yes, private member or public bill. Public bill, or sometimes it is also called as government bill. Public bill and government bill. And second is private member bill. Private member bill. Now, government bill is a one, the bill which is brought in the house by, yes, introduced in the house by minister. Yes, remember the word is minister, not the party or party in government. Okay, he minister, that is, he is an executive and he will bring the bill. The word is minister here. Private member bill is any other ordinary member, likh raha hu ya fir member of house. Member of house who is not minister. Because minister is also a member of house. Member who is not minister. Now do not get confused. Generally we tend to see that this must be an opposition member. He can be an opposition member, but he can be a from a BJP party also who is not a minister. In present scenario, say for example, BJP is having a government. So only within the BJP, those who are the ministers, if ministers are bringing, then it is called as public bill and government bill. Otherwise, any member who is not a minister, be it from the BJP party or otherwise, okay, that member bill is called as private member bill. Okay, government member bill and private member bill. Second thing is, what is important here is, here you require only 7 days prior notice to be given to the house. So with the 7 days prior notice, you can introduce the bill. So it means that they have the advantage. Here how much days prior notice is required? 30 days. Okay, 30 days prior notice is required here. Another important aspect here is, whatever the bill that is being drafted, this bill is, because they are the ministers, so they get all the support from their respective ministry. So it is a responsibility of or you can say that that particular minister is getting assisted by their ministry. So ministry is going to draft the bill. So here there is a support by the different departments and the ministries to draft the bill. But here that single individual member is responsible for drafting the bill. He will not get any assistant because it's his bill. In a way, it means that even if the legislature is there, in case of parliamentary form of government, the government side enjoys the enjoys the authority in order to bringing the more number of bills, and it's the easy way. First of all, 7 days notice, yahan pe 30 days notice lagegi. Second thing is, yahan pe jo bill hai, that is, you will get a lot of help. Here, you don't get any help. Okay. Example, Dr. Shashi Tharoor has brought one bill which has not even been accepted earlier. Yes, LGBT rights. So, in that regard, he has to give the 30 days prior notice, and he himself is single-handedly responsible. Otherwise, yahan pe agar LGBT problem aa jayega, kaun sa minister, ministry, wo bhi hai a difficult problem. Kaun sa ministry ko bheja jaye to draft the bill. Okay. Which ministry should at all, if the government is thinking of? Social and justice ministry, health ministry, law ministry. Yes, generally it is taken by the law ministry's assistance in each case, but all such controversial cases are generally taken by the law ministry. Okay. Anyways, so that's not in point here. 7 days prior notice and the bill responsibility. Now finally, generally these bills will get passed because in case of a parliamentary form of government, the government enjoy the majority on the house. So by default, all the bills get, governments get bill passed, at least in this case, but obviously in case of Rajya Sabha, things will be different and difficult. Here, one more point you should remember, whenever this bill is not getting passed, so it may amount to losing the majority on the floor of the house. What does it mean? If the government has brought the bill and government bill is not getting passed, it will amount to, yes, that is a loss of majority, and maybe it will be accompanied by the no confidence motion and the government will get unseated, because it will give a signal that government has lost the majority. This is specifically all the more important if your government is a coalition government. Coalition government hai, jaise 1-2-3 nuclear agreement ke liye aapne bill laya, and the left is not in support of you, otherwise left was given you a support. So left has taken, and then it means that now the government has lost the majority. So maybe the no confidence can be brought in.
This is only in case of money bill or any other?
Nay, any other. See, I'll tell you, in case of money bill and rest of the bill, what happens? That it directly means that there is a no confidence motion. Okay, some of the other rest of the things, you have to, it needs to be accompanied by the no confidence motion. Okay? And private members will obviously nothing happens. In fact, his bill never get passed until and unless it is just a procedural aspect. Matlab, very, very non-controversial and matlab, jisme koi debate hi nahi hai. Okay. Say, for example, increasing the salaries of the aise kuch hayega, ya phir, matlab, bahut hi, matlab, haan, procedural part rahega. And if at all it get passed, okay, he gets a lot of publicity. But this does not happen. We don't have much of the... culture of private member bringing the bill and it is getting passed. Okay, otherwise in case of America, there is a lot many chance. This is for a simple reason also, because legislature is completely separate organ in case of America. Are you understanding? So these are the simple classification, but many a times this 30 days, one day, minister, ye question yaad rakho ki it is any member, he can be a part of the government party, but who is not a minister. Okay, so this is about the one classification, which is not so important classification. Now the most important classification is depending upon the matter of the bill. The classification depending upon matter of bill. What is the matter in the bill? So there are four types. One is called as ordinary bill. Second is money bill, okay, or let me put it in a more technical way, that is a financial bill, iske three subtypes hai, that is a money bill, then financial bill category 1, and financial bill category 2. Financial bill cat 1, cat 2, and money bill. In fact, constitution writes this way, that is, there is a three category of financial bills. So money bill, what is the article? 110. So whatever is defined, we will discuss this later on. Just at this point of time, we are making a classification. This is article 117 clause 1 and article 117 clause 3. Okay. So this is financial bill, and the third one is constitutional amendment bill. If you have to amend the constitution, constitutional amendment bill. Constitutional amendment bill. In fact, this constitutional amendment bill is a bill under the article 368, because you can amend by ordinary process also. Some of the things can be amended in the constitution, but they are not called as constitutional amendment bill. Jaise humne dekha hai ki article 2 and 3, okay, so whatever is being passed, although there will be a change in the constitution, but it is still be termed as ordinary bill. Okay, so these are the three important classifications, that is ordinary bill, financial bill, and constitutional bill. Ordinary bill is the bill which is not financial bill and constitutional bill. Matlab, all the ordinary matter. Maximum jo rehta hai, wo ordinary bill rehta hai. How do you define? All matter except that does not come under the financial or money bill and the constitutional bill. So all the day-to-day and regular matter is an ordinary bill, that is an ordinary matter. Money bill, article 110 mein jitne jo likha hua hai, all those matters. Okay, financial, we'll see this definition later on. And constitutional is about constitutional amendment. Why this classification is important? Because the procedure for the passage of the bill is different from each one of these three things differently. And the power of president to reject, accept, and etc. is different from this bill. So there are different procedures. Most important procedure that is this, and then with respect to this, we are going to relatively make comparative analysis that how this procedure and this procedure is different from the ordinary procedure. Okay, so now let's come to the procedure for passage of bill or law making procedure. Okay. Law making procedure. Now this procedure, okay. They call it, this is by three readings. Three readings. Now these three readings or three stages. Sometimes three readings or three stages. These three stages are required in both the houses, whether it is a Lok Sabha or whether it is a Rajya Sabha. So these three stages will be there in both. No matter whether the bill originate here and then go here or originate here and then go here. Okay, in both the cases, they required to be passed by three stages. Okay, so we will see what are the three stages. In fact, these three stages are known as first reading, second reading, and third reading. First reading, second reading, and third reading. Now, many a times questioner asks, and you should very particular about what kind of the shape the bill gets in the first, second, and third, how they are different from each other, etc. So be it any house, the three readings will be there. So let us go one by one. What is the first reading? Now, ordinary bill can be produced in any house. It can be produced in Lok Sabha or it can be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Introduction of bill can be in both the house. Whichever is the house that gets the number one. Okay, that is the first house and the second house. So here the number is not fixed, which is the first and which is the second. It depends upon the in which house you have introduced the bill. So let us suppose we have introduced the bill in the Lok Sabha. So it will go through the three readings and then it will go through the Rajya Sabha in three readings. So what is the first reading? First reading, yes, what is it called as? Yes, introduction of bill. Okay, introduction of bill. This is about introduction of bill. First reading is about introduction of bill. So in this case, the bill is introduced. That is, the parliamentarians are made familiar with the bill. Now, how to make them familiar with the bill? See, before the introduction, you require here the leave of the house. Leave is permission. Okay. Right. Permission or the leave of the house. Permission when granted, then you will introduce the bill. That is introduction. Now, introduction of the bill, what does it mean? So, if I have to present the bill, it means that introduction involves reading the titles of the bill and reading the objective of bill. That's it. There is no discussion here. So, the one minister, Rene Do Ya Fair, this is private member. He can be a minister or he can be a either of the two only. Okay, so whether he is a prime minister or whether private member or a minister, he will introduce. Introduction involves only reading the titles of the bill and reading the broader objectives of bill. Okay, bracket mein likh lo, no discussion. Okay, so no person is saying anything, just it is about the one who is introducing the bill. Second is, the moment he has read the titles and the objective, okay, for public purpose and to know larger part, the bill is published. The bill is published in Gazette. The bill is published in Gazette. So these two things are required in introduction, that is reading the titles and objectives and publication of bill in the Government Gazette. This completes the first reading. So first reading, two, three, permission to leni. See, the thing is, in case of a permission, sometimes the publication of Gazette happen before it is being introduced on the floor. Okay, publish aap pehle bhi kar sakte ho, introduction ke, ya fir baad mein bhi kar sakte ho. It is your choice. If you have published the bill into the Gazette before introduction on the house, you need not require to take a separate permission. It means that people are already aware about it and the parliamentarians are already aware about it. Are you understanding? But in any case, you have to do the publication of Gazette, introduction on the floor of the house. Introduction on the floor of the house and publication of the bill in the Gazette completes the first reading. No discussion. Again, I'm focusing. No discussion at all happens here. Okay, why this is important publication? Because it's not just the parliamentarians should come to know about it. It's the people of India should also come into know about it. Yes, this bill is coming and it will be debated, discussed, etc. People will also come up with their opinion through the pressure groups, interest groups, through the social media, articles, newspapers, etc. Because it will have a bearing on the second stage. Okay, we will see that what happens in the second reading. So second stage involves, okay, that is a, now in case of a second stage, see, there is a head of that particular house, but there is a business committee. So business committee will see the timeline and give the permission and etc. Ye permission bol rahe ho na aap ye? Yes. Yes. Business committee of the house karke ek business committee hai. Yes, which bills to be introduced, when to be introduced, what is the timeline, and then the speaker takes the bill. Okay. Now, second reading. Now, second reading is the most important stage because the bill achieves its final stage, or you can say that the final shape here. Okay. Second reading is the most important one. Second reading, there are three sub-stages. Okay, there are three sub-stages. Okay, first sub-stage is called as general discussion. See, the word now coming is a discussion. There, what was the word? Introduction. There is no discussion at all. General discussion. Second stage is known as committee stage. And third stage is called as consideration stage. Consideration stage. Okay, general discussion, committee stage, and consideration stage. Now see, what has happened here so far, that is the first reading has happened, which is introduction of bill, which means title plus objective, and then publication of bill. Now here there is a no involvement of member of parliaments. Now from the second, now there will be a general, the word is general discussion. It means that there is no detailed discussion. There is no detailed discussion. So whatever the objectives are there, broad objectives are discussed. Broadly, member of parliaments, in principle, there is a discussion going on. Okay, so there is a general discussion. And there is no, so when I say general discussion, it means only a general and it is not detailed discussion. It is not clause by clause discussion. Not clause by clause. Okay? It's a very general discussion. So after a general discussion, the House will take one decision. See, there are few bills they can directly take to the consideration stage. Okay, what will happen, I'll discuss here. This is not a mandatory, this is optional. But nowadays, convention has already been developed, that the bill goes to the committee stage. But if the parliamentarians want, after the general discussion, they can directly take here. But one of the reasons why they will go for this is because, as we have just now said, in case of a parliamentary form of government, the composition of parliamentarian is very sort of mediocre. Okay, so they cannot scrutinize and titles and etc. etc. So the committee stage will give you a complete, in-depth, comprehensive discussion on that. So obviously, the member of parliamentarians will give the bill to the committee stage, and committee stage will make everything in detail. Okay, so general stage se committee stage mein bill ja raha hai. Now, which are this committee? There can be a possibility of two types of committees hai yahan pe. There are two types of committees. One is the select committee and second is the joint committee. Okay, select committee or joint committee. Now, let us understand what is this select committee and joint committee. We have said that the bill will be introduced either in the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha. If the committee is formed by only one house where the bill has been introduced, it is called as select committee. That is, the bill jisme introduce kiya gaya hai, usi bill, usi house ki committee rahegi, only that house, then it is called as select house. So only one house members are there. And here both members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are there. So they will take the decision. Generally, this decision is based upon ki ekhad controversial bill hai. That bill is going to be discussed in other house in detail also. Agar aapko pehle se hi pata hai, so why not to build the consensus since inception itself? Okay. So what you are going to do is you will involve the member of Rajya Sabha or the whatever the second house is. So you will involve the members. So it is an optional ki kahan pe bhejna hai. Select committee is the single house member committee, and joint committee is the member from the both the houses. So what the committee member do? Committee member will not do the general discussion. They will go to the detailed scrutiny of the bill. Detailed scrutiny of the bill. They will discuss the bill. What is the detailed scrutiny mean? They will discuss the bill clause by clause. They will also propose the amendments. They will also propose the amendments. So everything is, so in-depth, detailed scrutiny is in-depth, comprehensive discussion, comprehensive scrutiny. So this is a very important stage because this is otherwise a formal things. Here the bill actually is getting the final shape in this case. Okay, the detailed scrutiny is happening, clause by clause discussion and the amendment. Committee, obviously, it's a small group of people, so obviously there is a very detailed discussion also happens. Okay, in this case, that's why I said that in case of a gazette, you have already published the bill, so there is a lot of public opinion is also generated. Committee will also take into consideration what is the expectation of the people, what are the suggestions by the different pressure groups. So everything will be detailed and a detailed report will be made. At the final end of the committee stage, they will make the report on the bill. They will give the report on bill and this report will go back into the house. Okay, this report will go back into the house, and in consideration stage, now in consideration stage, they will see the report will act as a facilitator for discussion. Okay, now here there is a yahan pe jo general discussion ho gaya tha, parliamentarians also now going to do the detailed discussion based upon the report of committee stage. So report becomes a facilitator for them because that becomes a summary of all the bill. And they will discuss the report also, and they will discuss the bill also. So here again, there is a detailed discussion. There is a detailed discussion. Same thing, detailed discussion when we are writing, it means that clause by clause discussion is there. If there can be amendments that can be proposed, amendments bhi aa jayenge usme. Okay, and finally, clause by clause voting will happen. Okay, clause by clause voting will happen. See, the bill as such completely is not voted. That you should remember. Okay, as a whole bill is not voted here, only clause by clause. It means that the bill is achieving its final shape in the second stage. Kai bar question pucha jata hai ki bill achieve the final stage in which stage? It is the second stage. Second reading. This is even if the third stage you should not call it that is a third reading and etc. This is within the second reading only. So general discussion by the House, then the House is giving it to the committee for the detailed report, and then detailed report is coming back to the House, and then they are making the detailed discussion on the report and going for the voting clause by clause. Okay, not bill as a whole. Clause by clause voting will be there, and amendments are also moved. Amendments as suggested by committee. Amendments as suggested by committee. See, the one more thing is committee, although detailed scrutiny is there, but larger framework of the bill cannot be disturbed. Okay, aisa nahi hai ki committee will propose altogether a new bill. They can propose the amendments within the broader fundamental principle of the bill. So everything it will get the shape that is amendments also. Now come to the third stage. Okay, third reading. Third reading. The question in front of the House is very simple. This is the simplest. Okay, jada matlab isme dimag nahi lagana hai. The simple thing that is there is a question in front of the House now whether to make bill law or not, or to pass the bill or not. To pass the bill or not. So this was the question. So therefore, there is a voting on bill as whole. This is important. Not clause by clause. Clause by clause voting is in the second stage only. So voting on the bill as whole. And if, what is the majority required? Simple majority. If the House passed by the simple majority, that is majority of present and voting. Majority of present and voting. I'll take the separate class on the different majorities, maybe tomorrow. Okay, separately, what all types of majority which are there in constitution. Okay, so at this, remember that is a present and voting. Key simple majority, then bill stands passed by the particular House. Now, what about the amendments, and can amendments moved at this particular stage in the third reading? Ab lag raha hai ki amendments? No. A small change, cosmetic change here and there. Some words, some spelling to rahega. Matlab, not very significant change. Not very significant change, not to be called as an amendment. Okay. So amendments are not allowed. So in third reading, basic question in front of the House is to pass the bill and to go for the voting of the bill as a whole, not as a parts. Understood? So this is about the third reading. Let's revise this in 1 minute. What is the first reading? That is an introduction. And what is the introduction? Reading the titles and the objectives and plus publication in the gazette. Obviously, permission bolne ki jarurat nahi hai kyunki permission to rahegi hi rahegi. Introduction of the bill involves two things. That is reading the titles and the objectives for the parliamentarians and publication in the gazette. Then it comes to the second reading. Second reading has three stages. General discussion stage, committee stage, and the consideration stage. General discussion, it's a very general discussion. Okay, no, there is no discussion at all in the first stage. Okay, so it is here the discussion is happening by the parliamentarians, but no clause by clause, no amendments. They can take the decision whether to send it for committee stage or take directly for the, yes. So they generally, now the already the culture has been developed, it will go to the committee stage. Committee stage, it can be a select committee and joint committee. Then yes, it will go detailed scrutiny of the bill, clause by clause scrutiny, amendments, okay, and they will make the report. Okay, they can only propose the amendment. Do not think that amendment, matlab they themselves can make the amendments and that becomes an amendment. Ultimately, amendment will be voted lastly, finally by the consideration stage. So they will propose the amendments, they will do a report. This report is considered in the third stage. And in third stage, again, they will discuss also. See, remember, many a times it happens that third stage became a third reading. Okay, it's not. It's just the consideration stage. Consideration stage may clause by clause discussion as well as voting happen here, but voting is only clause by clause. Okay, clause ye hoga ya nahi hoga is bill mein. That becomes the third, and then finally the third reading where the, yes, as a whole, and what is majority required, that is a simple majority. Okay, now once it has been happened, the speaker generally, it is called as endorsing the bill. So speaker uske upar ek endorse kar deta hai, ki our house, speaker matlab, it can be a speaker or it can be a chairperson. Okay, jo bhi, agar first bill wahan pe emerge hua hai, Rajya Sabha mein, so they will endorse the bill, that bill has been passed and this is a simple bill or ordinary bill. So this bill will go into the second house. Second house, same procedure will be there. Same procedure will be there, first reading, second reading, third reading, except agar joint committee wahan pe already established ho chuki hai, toh, they will not go for the again committee, they will directly go for the consideration stage. So the bill will be passed, and now the bill when passed by both the houses, shall we call now it as an act? No, we cannot call act because it will go for the assent of the president. So what is the president is going to do? President has three options. Now it is going into the president. President has three options. Either to give the assent, which generally he does because he is just a nominal head, or second, he can reject the bill, or third, he can send it for reconsideration. Sent it for reconsideration. So if he gives the assent, then bill becomes act, which generally happens. Which generally happens that bill becomes act, and therefore it becomes a part of law. He rejects the bill, it is called as the veto, absolute veto. Absolute veto. We will discuss what are the different types of veto later on. Here, let us put this way only. Okay, generally he cannot, in many of the cases, he cannot, except in few of the cases, we'll see later. Reconsideration, only once. He can send it for reconsideration, only once. It means that if the House will pass the bill in the without any changes, then he must have to give the assent. Now there is no possibility of reconsideration. So reconsideration can be done only once. So even if the bill is passed by both the houses of the parliament, if he is not happy with the bill, he will say that please reconsider it again. And he might give the suggestions also, or he might not give the suggestions. But if the bill is passed in the same way without any change, second time he has to give the assent. So it becomes the act. So this is a for the procedure for the ordinary bill. Okay. Anybody has any doubt so far?
Sir, if the bill goes to the other house, huh, the other house forms a select committee, and then that select committee proposes an amendment.
Huh.
Yes,
we are going to see that. We are going to see that amendment. See, the thing is that the bill, if goes from the one house, goes into the second house. Second house proposed the new amendments. Now, the new amendments will not become immediately considered as a part of the act. That amendment are proposed by the second house. So, if there is a changes has happened, it will again come to the first house for those amendments. So anything that has to be added in the ordinary law, ordinary bill, it must, every single word has to be accepted by both the houses. So inhone naya propose kiya to wo fir se wapas aa jayega, theek hai, and they have to pass the bill. Okay, so that's हाँ, voting only generally will be considered. वो लिखा रहता है कि ये amendment है, should we accept or not? So directly, वो three stage नहीं होगा. Okay, it will be just like the house whether to accept this amendments or not. Okay. Now we are coming to a peculiar situation. In fact, that leads us to the peculiar situation called as deadlock between the two houses. There is a possibility of deadlock. It's not that every time both the houses will sing in a same rhythm. Okay, so they may go out of the rhythm, and this will lead into the deadlock between the two houses. I hope this much is clear. Okay. In fact, that is, we cannot call it fourth stage, but yes, that's the situation. So that is how the how to resolve the deadlock. That is through the joint sitting. Okay. First of all, we will discuss what is a deadlock between the two houses. Deadlock between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. When the deadlock can happen? See, there are two houses. So, first house and second house. Here I am not writing first as a Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, but it can be any house. It can be first is Lok Sabha or first is Rajya Sabha. So, deadlock happens in three cases. That first house passed the bill, but second house has not passed or rejected the bill. Okay, they have not passed. Jo bhi simple majority hai, simple majority se nahi pass hua hai. First house has passed and second house has suggested the amendments. Amendments, and as just now I have said, this automatically does not become amendments. They are only proposing the amendments. Okay, so rather better word is, if the second house has proposed the amendments and these proposed amendments are not accepted. Okay, first case is this, second case is this. It has passed, they have proposed the amendments and there is a disagreement. So in a small word, disagreement over the over amendments. Disagreement over the amendments. And the third position is, first house has passed the bill and there is a 6 months have lapsed and the second house has not taken any bill. Bill is pending in the second house. Bill is pending in the second house and pending and 6 months has already lapsed. So these three cases are called as deadlock. It means that deadlock is a disagreement between the two houses. So disagreement between the two houses can happen out of three things. Either of the house is completely rejecting the bill, or there is a disagreement over the amendment, or there is a no passage of the bill for the 6 months. Understood? These three situations are called as deadlock. Now, generally kya hai ki ordinary bill mein ek simple sa hai ki the bill has to be accepted by both the houses. So many a times deadlock solve karna must nahi hai. It is not a must case. If say for example first house, second house has rejected, the bill can be dropped altogether. Bill get killed. Okay. Ye aisi constitutional obligation nahi hai ki inka resolve kiya jaye. Amendments are proposed, amendments are not accepted, bill will not go further. Okay, or 6 months pending hai, so it's a sort of a silence is rejection type wala type. Okay, so it will be again dropped. But there is a, if at all a bill is very important and if you feel like resolving the deadlock, then there is a constitutional provision. Okay, no, this is an optional provision, not necessary, that is a joint sitting. Joint sitting of the house. So we will see that joint sitting of the house and what are the provisions related with the joint sitting. Joint sitting of the house. So, such kind of joint sitting, the word, what is the meaning of joint sitting? That both houses will come together. That is a Lok Sabha plus Rajya Sabha. That is called as joint. They are sitting together now. Now, when it happens? Only when there is a deadlock. Only when there is a deadlock between the two houses. And deadlock emerge out of three situations or three conditions. Three conditions that we have already seen. Rejection of bill, disagreement over the amendment and not passage of the bill for 6 months. So deadlock seems to have occurred. So now one can resolve. Optional situation. Now who takes the call? It's a president. Who will take the call? It is the president who summon. Okay. Who summon? Nahi. Wo chair karta hai. Okay. President will summon the joint sitting. That's why this word are important. Okay. President summons the house. Summons the joint sitting. Okay, so it's the prerogative. Obviously, president, matlab council of minister, it's the government, it's the executive. It's not his discretionary power. So, if the government, say for example, something like in this case of government, the government passed the bill from the Lok Sabha, some populistic measures they have taken, they do not enjoy the majority in the Rajya Sabha, Rajya Sabha has rejected it, or Rajya Sabha has not taken the decision for 6 months altogether, or propose some erratic amendments which are not accepted by the, okay, or genuine amendments which are not accepted for the populistic measure. Either of the thing can happen. Now the government feel that this is very important bill, populistic bill, and or otherwise important bill. So they can ask the president to summon the house, because they know that ultimately, we will see that ultimately Lok Sabha since has a power, number, maximum number, so it gets a upper hand. President will summon the joint sitting. So joint sitting aa gayi hai yahan pe. Now, who will preside the joint sitting? That is important. Yes. Who will preside the joint sitting? So this is different from summoning. Okay, remember this word. Kai bar 1, 2, 3, 4 karke statements aate hai. The joint sitting is summoned by speaker. Matlab wo over enthusiasm mein, haan, speaker hi hai, pata hai. Thik hai? Nahi hai. Summoned by president. Okay, presided by speaker. It is presided by speaker. If speaker is absent, then deputy speaker. If deputy speaker is absent, then yes, not panel of deputy chairperson, chairman or chairperson. Why, what is the difference between chairman and chairperson? No, I am asking the word chairman and chairperson. Think and tell. I am asking very simple question. The word is chairman and chairperson. Aray, it has nothing to do with the constitution. Okay, itna matli dimag lagao. I am not asking the difference between vice president and deputy chairperson hai or chairperson hai. I am asking chairman and chairperson mein difference kya hai. Yes. Chairman is always a male. Are you sure? So it means that vice president, women can never be a vice president in India if it is chairman. You are very close, but slight thoda sa usme modification required hai. Yes. Yes. Anyone? Should I write here chairman or chairperson? Yes, anyone? And chairman is? Wow, aise hai. Temporary end. See, this is the symbolic of feminist movement. Okay? Feminist, radical feminism, pata hai? Radical feminism see that there is a lot of patriarchy, and this patriarchy get reflected in different words. Okay, one of the word is when we use the chairman, there is already inherent patriarchal mindset behind it. So nowadays, generally in government documents, you will not find the word chairman. It is always written as a chairperson. Constitution mein chairman milega, lekin ab jo matlab lokpal, lokayukta ya jo bhi naye naye cheeze hai usme chairperson. So this is a revolution of feminism in India. Okay, otherwise radical feminist. Radical feminist. Kabhi dekha hai ki Arundhati Roy pehle kya likhti hai? Mrs. Arundhati Roy likhte hai wo kabhi? Have you seen Arundhati Roy writing Mrs. Arundhati Roy? She writes Miss. She writes Arundhati Roy. Okay, nowadays feminists do not write Mrs. Mrs. is after Mr. It's a secondary identity. So feminists, matlab strong feminists do not write Mrs. Earlier they used to take a pride in it, but now they say that we are not others. We are not second in number. Okay, so that's the thing. Otherwise, ethics class mein maine bataya tha. Those who have attended, I think forgotten. Anyways, so Deputy Speaker, Deputy Chairperson, the catch here is chairperson or chairman will never become a, yes, sitting the, presiding the house. Generally, who is there? Where is the head of the Rajya Sabha? Yes, Vice President or the Chairman. So Chairman is not, so first is the Speaker, second is the Deputy Speaker. Here Deputy Chairman is, so yahan pe Chairman word nahi hai, ye yaad rakho. Okay, why he do not sit? Because he is not a member of either of the house. Okay, Vice President is not member of either of the house, so therefore he do not sit. Okay, first, second, third, and the last, now, as agreed by the house members, matlab jo joint sitting hai. As agreed by the joint sitting member. So fourth is as agreed by the house. All the rules and the procedures of joint sitting are governed by rules of Lok Sabha. Okay, all the rules. Okay, ye kabhi 1, 2, 3, 4 mein pooch sakte. The one presided by ek statement denge. The it is governed by rules of Rajya Sabha ya Lok Sabha dekhenge, right and wrong. So it is governed by rules of Lok Sabha and not by Rajya Sabha. Quorum, how much quorum is required? Quorum means minimum presence. 1/10 of Lok Sabha or 1/10 of Rajya Sabha? Huh? 1/10 of sum total of both. 1/10 of both the, yes, that is the sum total. Total membership of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Okay, 1/10 of total membership of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So three things remember. One is the who, five things basically. Who summons it? President summons it. Who presides it? Speaker, and this is the here. Rules are followed by rules of Lok Sabha. Quorum is 1/10. And the passage of bill by which majority? Simple majority. It is by the simple majority, no special majority. This was, I think, asked last year. Okay, this question was asked. That is joint sitting. The passage of the bill in the joint sitting is through the simple majority. Okay, which majority? So it's the simple majority. Now, since think of this way, that because the number of Lok Sabha, kitne log hai? 550 approximately we are taking, okay, and this 250. So 250 ke 125 lagenge aur yahan pe generally 225 lagta hai separately. But if they will club together, yahan pe jara 270, haan, 5, haan, chalo, theek hai, approximately kar lena. So here the total membership kya ho gaya? 800. Now here 125 minimum lagna tha aapko. Say for example, Rajya Sabha has created the deadlock and there were only 120 people were ready. Now there is no significance here because this 10 members agar yahan se jyada badh gaye, so automatically Lok Sabha will get upper hand sheer out of the number. Okay, because the simple majority ka jo calculation aa jayega. Okay, so this is the procedure. Again, I'll repeat it. This is an optional procedure. All the deadlock need not have to be resolved. How many times this mechanism has been used? 3 times only. Okay, one is for the domestic violence bill, then banking commission, repeal bill, and then POTA. POTA, that is already abolished act, so for that also. So only 3 times joint sitting has been used. Only 3 times joint sitting has been used. Also remember one more thing about the joint sitting. If the Lok Sabha, say for example, a bill is proposed by the Lok Sabha, okay, introduce. It goes into the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha make the amendment. And then there is a dissolution of Lok Sabha. So in such case, joint sitting is possible? No, joint sitting is not possible. But if the president has already said that we will have a joint sitting and after that there is a dissolution has happened. Okay? If once the president has declared the summoning of joint sitting, and if the Lok Sabha has dissolved even after that, so new Lok Sabha will sit for the joint sitting. Are you understanding? Even if Lok Sabha is dissolved. But if the Lok Sabha is dissolved and the president has not said anything, then there will not be a joint sitting. Understood? So these are the some of the aspects. This is the main point. Whenever there is a deadlock, should joint sitting be used frequently? That is one. Is the joint sitting a good option for the ordinance making power? Okay, there are two options. There are two options available in constitution. If the bill is not passed, say in case of present government, karte hai, ki present government is not having a majority in the Rajya Sabha and they enjoy a good majority on the Lok Sabha. So any bill, they have the difficulty in passing through the Rajya Sabha, they have two options constitutionally. One is, forget about anything, go for the ordinance route. Go through the ordinance making power. And second is, convey the joint sitting. Because you have upper hand in the Lok Sabha, you will get upper hand in the Rajya Sabha. Yes, should it be frequently used tool in order to resolve the current crisis? And what are its implications? If yes, why yes? If no, why no? Subvert the democracy, how? Okay, I understand that the ordinance making power bypasses the legislature. What about the joint sitting? Why it passes? Rajya Sabha to hai na yahan pe joint sitting mein. Yes, in fact, this is very clear cut. The two houses significance will lost. Okay, jo bicameral legislature hai. Bicameral legislature ka significance ye hai. Okay, any second house is a revision house. Okay, it is tried to scrutinize the house. Not only in case of Rajya Sabha, if you see in particularly that represents the state at the central level. So there are good reasons for which the bicameral legislation has been created. So it will be like, spirit of democracy, spirit of constitution, spirit of democratic process. It is like killing that. Technically, you are right, but if you see the constitutional morality, constitutional spirit, it is against the ethos of democratic passage of the bill. In between, say for example, in between joint sitting and ordinance, which will be better? Joint sitting. Think. Why joint sitting and why not ordinance making?
It has to be presented before the ordinance.
Who? Ordinance is better? नहीं नहीं अरे एक आंसर बताइए मुझे कि इन बिटवीन द ऑर्डिनेंसेस एंड जॉइंट सिटिंग विच वन इज बेटर हाँ जॉइंट सिटिंग इज बेटर देयर इज यस एनीवन व्हाई यस फाइनली ऑर्डिनेंस में यू हैव टू पुट फॉरवर्ड ऑर्डिनेंस इन फ्रंट ऑफ द बोथ द हाउसेस विच हैज टू बी इक्वली पास्ड जॉइंट सिटिंग में तो आप एक हाउस ओवर रिच कर ही रहा है नहीं रिपोमुलगेशन दैट इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग ऑल टुगेदर बट विद इन द सिक्स मंथ्स ओके यू हैव टू प्लेस हाउ मेनी टाइम्स यू विल रिप्रोमुलगेट ऑलरेडी द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज सेड फॉर द सेम सब्जेक्ट एंड द सेम मैटर यू कैन नॉट रिप्रोमुलगेट ठीक है रिपोमुलगेशन फॉर द सेम सब्जेक्ट इन केस ऑफ यस दैट इट डज नॉट मीन दैट आई एम साउंडिंग लाइक आई एम प्रमोटिंग द ऑर्डिनेंस व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज ordinance making ultimately you have to come to the legislature and it has to be equally passed by both the houses equally separately here what you are doing is ultimately there is no relevance at all of the Rajya Sabha theek hai but yes both are not within the spirit of parliamentary democracy or the constitutional that has to be sparingly used otherwise in a different class we will take that discussion okay
that is
Yes, we will discuss. Yes. Yes, yes. Yes, that is a part of means. There are, you have a point. I'm not saying that way. Okay, you have a point that, see, the point is again not about the Rajya Sabha, should the power of Rajya Sabha curtailed. The point is, Rajya Sabha ki power jitni hai, thik thak hai, aur jitne mein nahi hai, thik thak hai. What is important is, the culture that has to be developed. What is a culture? A democratic culture. What has happened in case of India? The opposition is going to always oppose, okay, whoever it is. So that culture was wrong. It is not wrong with the system as such. It's the people who are going with the the present institutional mechanism. They are, in fact, there is an intention in order to defeat the bill. That is more important. So parliamentary culture, jo hai, parliamentary culture requires a constructive debate. As it is a responsibility of the government of the day to pass the bill, it is equally responsibility of the opposition also to pass the bill. As it is responsibility of opposition, it is also responsibility of government to generate the consensus. Here, you cannot point the fingers only at the Congress or only at the BJP. Both are responsible because one is having a complete defiant attitude that we will not let it pass, and one is having a defiant attitude we will not have a all party meeting and generate the consensus and that's the so on and so forth. Are you understanding? So yes, your debate, that debate is fine, but we have to take into account the other things. Like say for in case of a bunny bill and rest of the bill, already their power is not there. So there is no problem for the budget and etc. So ultimately, if you have created an house, there is a certain reason and rationale behind creation of that house also. Popular will represent karta, it does not also means that anything should threaten the or any such kind of the bill which is not in favor of nation at large should get passed in hastiness as a part of a populistic. But again, usme kafi dono ke points likhne padte means mein. We will not discuss, okay? So let's go to the now money bill. Any question, any doubt, otherwise on the procedure and this thing. Otherwise we can go to the money bill. Yes. Can select committee or joint committee reject the bill? No. They cannot do anything. They cannot do except they can propose and recommend. Reject koi nahi kar sakta. Reject and accept is the final authority of the house, whether to accept or whether to reject. Yes, they can suggest, they can recommend, this bill is not with the spirit of constitution and hereby it should not be there. Okay, they can only. But ultimately, third stage mein clause by clause hoga aur third reading mein uske upar bill as a vote will put forward for voting. Yes, there can be a possibility. Say for example, there are 22 members in the select committee. And the committees are not formed by only one party. There is a proportional representation. We will see in the committees, proportional representation. So for example, if the member from the opposition party is having a opposite view on a bill, he feels that this bill is wrong. So when the report is put in front of the parliament, there is a dissenting notes. Okay, dissenting notes by those who feel or who is in disagreement with the committee. So note mein likha rehta hai wo. Okay, be it of any kind of a commission. That's a general practice that the decision is taken by the majority. Okay, and after that there will be a dissenting notes if a person has to give. But ultimately it's the majority which prevails. So no, they cannot reject it. Only they can make the suggestions. Yes. Yes, now let's consider this aspect. In fact, they cannot change anything except within what is given in the what is given in the broader framework of the bill. Okay, they cannot change anything that I have already mentioned, so they have to work within the broader framework. Okay, so let's write about the something regarding the money bill. Okay. Yes. No, it cannot be certain. Aise koi guarantee nahi hai. What about if the deadlock, agar Lok Sabha majority nahi hai, deadlock has happened because of Lok Sabha, not because of Rajya Sabha. We have given a special situation that whatever the Lok Sabha's wish, that wish can be yes, that wish can be no. Agar Lok Sabha was discomfortable about the bill, then such bill will not get passed. It is the wish of the Lok Sabha which get a prevalence. You cannot 100% say, but yes, it is because of number. ये ऐसा है ना कि bill राज्य सभा से originate हुआ है और लोक सभा में गया, लोक सभा में pending रहा है, उनको नहीं pass करना है, तो वो pass नहीं हो जाएगा. GST, yes, no. GST is a constitutional amendment bill. Okay. GST is a constitutional amendment bill. Constitutional amendment bill, yes. One more point, last point you can write just in case of joint sitting. Joint sitting is only for the ordinary bill. In fact, this was an important point. Only for the ordinary bill. So, what about the money bill? No. Why? There is no possibility of deadlock. Because 14 day ke baad agar Rajya Sabha nahi de raha hai, toh it is deemed as passed. So there will not be an, we will see that. So the, in case of money bill, there is no deadlock. And what about the constitutional bill? Why there is no joint sitting? It has to be passed, must, by both the houses, by the Lok Sabha and by the Rajya Sabha. Constitutional amendment bill mein Rajya Sabha bhi pass karna padega, Lok Sabha bhi pass. It is a must. So there is no provision of deadlock here. Okay, money bill, there is no deadlock because Lok Sabha. Money bill, there is no deadlock because Lok Sabha get upper hand over the Rajya Sabha. Constitutional amendment bill is not because Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha both should pass the bill. Okay, so it's financial bill ki hum baad mein dekhenge. Financial bills jo cat 1 cat 2 hai kis category mein aate, they are like a ordinary bill. Okay, for the joint sitting purpose. Okay, they are like ordinary bill. Financial bill cat 1 and cat 2 jo likha tha usme joint sitting, they are otherwise considered as ordinary bill. I'll explain that. Let's come to the money bill. Money bill mein do cheeze hai. First we will see that what is money bill, and second is the procedure for the passage of money bill. Procedure for passage. What is money bill? Yes, how do you define the money bill? How do you define? Speaker decides. Okay, that is one. Yes, you should not define in any way other than two things. That is, what is written in Article 110. Money bill is a bill. Sorry, aise ulta likhta. Money bill is a bill that deals with the matter, that deals with the matters written in Article 110. So this is how you have to define it. Only matters or matter written in 110. And second, you may add it, and it has to be certified by, yes, by whom? Speaker. Remember this. It has to be certified by Speaker as a money bill. It has to be certified by as a money bill. So these are the two things. First is the bill which deals with the matter mentioned in 110, exclusively written. Okay, any other matter, iska thoda sa aur dusra aur matter hai, aise nahi chalega. 100% matter has to be from 110. This requires to be mentioned. Exclusive matter dealt with 110 because 117 ki definition alag hai. Theek hai? And certified by Speaker. Now, Speaker has a final authority which cannot be challenged any court of law. It cannot be challenged by President and it cannot be challenged by Parliament. So, any organ of the government, aise yaad kar sakte ho, judiciary mein kahin, no court of law can challenge. Executive mein, President cannot challenge, and legislature mein, Parliament cannot challenge. So his decision is final. That is, a Speaker of the Lok Sabha, or simply a Speaker, his decision cannot be challenged in any court of law. It cannot be challenged by the President. It cannot be challenged by Parliament. Okay, and this is very important power, and this is one of the reasons where today there is a controversy now with respect to Aadhaar Bill. Okay, so Aadhaar Bill, once Speaker says, okay, कौन सा मैडम है वो ठीक है हाँ इंदौर वाले हाँ सुमित्रा मैडम तो उन्होंने बोल दिया तो इट इज अनचैलेंज्ड ओके इट कैन नॉट बी चैलेंज्ड इन एनी कोर्ट सो वी विल सी दैट व्हाट आर द इम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ दिस लेटर ऑन बट दिस इज द डेफिनेशन नाउ लेट अस ब्रीफली सी व्हाट आर द मैटर इन आर्टिकल 110 ओके व्हाट इज द आर्टिकल 110 Now there are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, S likha hai. Simply hum understand karenge. See, the thing is that something you remember as a consolidation fund of India. कंसोलिडेशन फंड ऑफ इंडिया और दूसरा कौन सा फंड रहता है, कंटिजेंसी फंड एंड पब्लिक अकाउंट फंड, पब्लिक अकाउंट ऑफ इंडिया, क्या रहा है, पब्लिक अकाउंट कंटिजेंसी हो गया, पब्लिक अकाउंट कंटिजेंसी भी है, जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस, ओके, फंड जो भी गवर्नमेंट का फंड है। सो हाँ, थर्ड ही है, फर्स्ट, सो इसमें कुछ मनी आएगा, मनी कैन कम फ्रॉम द टैक्स एंड सेकंड कैन कम फ्रॉम नॉन टैक्स, व्हिच इज इम्पोर्टेंट वन इज द बोरोइंग। सो मनी कैन एंटर थ्रू द टैक्स एंड इट कैन एंटर थ्रू द बोरोइंग। मनी कैन बी विड्रॉन थ्रू द अप्रोप्रिएशन, appropriation bill, okay, you need to require an appropriation bill to withdraw the money out of the fund. Then there is a certain fund which you designate as a charged upon consolidation fund of India. I'll explain that what is it is charged upon consolidation, which is not being voted, okay. एंड देन जो भी अकाउंट रहता है उसकी ऑडिटिंग होती है, देर इज ऑलवेज ऑडिटिंग, ओके, एंड फाइनली द मैटर अदर, आई विल एक्सप्लेन नाउ व्हाट इज व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट थिंग्स, ओके। सो इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस ग्राफिक, सो ऑल द पॉइंट्स ऑफ आर्टिकल 1110 विल बी ओवर। सो फर्स्ट ए पॉइंट क्या है, दैट मैटर रिलेटेड विथ imposition of tax, alteration of tax, modification of tax, repealing of the tax, okay, so any matter, so if you have to propose the tax, so it is the money bill, again remember exclusive, matlab inme se hi matter honi chahiye, none of the other matter is come under, so proposal, acceptance, alteration, modification of tax will be considered as money bill. The matter dealing with the regulation of borrowing, रेगुलेशन ऑफ बोरोइंग मतलब मैक्सिमम मिनिमम, इतना बोरोइंग, इतने साल, इतना वगैरह वगैरह, एनी थिंग दैट इज डीलिंग विद द बोरोइंग विल बी अ पार्ट ऑफ मनी बिल। थर्ड इज और सी इज मनी कमिंग इन एंड गोइंग आउट ऑफ कंसोलिडेशन फंड ऑफ इंडिया, कंसोलिडेशन फंड और फॉर दैट मैटर पब्लिक अकाउंट ऑफ इंडिया, जो गवर्नमेंट का फंड है, मनी कमिंग इन एंड गोइंग आउट, ठीक है। गोइंग आउट के लिए आपको वेन एवर यू विड्रॉ द मनी यू रिक्वायर द पार्लियामेंट्री अप्रूवल, दैट इज थ्रू द अप्रोप्रिएशन। सो वेन यू विड्रॉ द मनी, सो दिस इज अ रिसिट साइड, ओके, और इन मनी इन लिखो एंड दिस इज आउट, ओके। सो मनी इज कमिंग इन इन द पॉकेट एंड मनी इज गोइंग आउट, money is going out, that is related, something related with appropriation bill. In fact, the appropriation bill has two components, that is a grant that has been accepted and second is something charged upon consolidation fund of India. So samajhne ke liye different likha hai, nahi to appropriation bill, whenever appropriation bill is passed, the amount of money that is passed within the appropriation is a sum total of grant and charged upon consolidation fund. So this is A, B, C, D, E, okay, then F is regarding the audit of all the accounts, okay, audit of consolidation fund of India, then public account, and then yes, state ki bhi jo rehta hai, consolidation fund of state, unka bhi yes scrutiny ho raha hai, okay, audit of all the, सी कौन कौन सा, उतना डिटेल नहीं पूछेंगे, इतना ही कि ऑडिट, समथिंग विच इज रिलेटेड विद द ऑडिट, इफ यू आर प्रपोजिंग समथिंग दैट्स ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ मनी बिल, एंड दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट वर्ड, कि ये छोड़ के भी द अदर मैटर इंसिडेंटल टू इट, अदर मैटर इंसिडेंटल टू इट, नाउ दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, वेयर इन आधार बिल के लिए आपको स्पेस मिल जाएगा, मतलब कोई और भी मैटर इंसिडेंटल to this all rest of the matters, if any matter is directly indirectly related. Now isme debate ho sakta hai ki opposition will say that this other matter is not a money bill, but who is the final authority? Speaker, okay, so they will term the Aadhaar bill as a money bill and speaker is the final arbiter, she will say that it is Aadhaar money bill, then nobody can challenge it. Okay? So this is one matter which gives a space to include some other matters also as a money bill. But this is again a very wrong practice, because once it happens, it sets the precedence. So such kind of the precedents are obviously wrong precedences. The more important thing is you should generate the consensus. That's the better way always. Understood? So these are the different parts within the money bill. It should exclusively deal with this matter. That word is important. Okay? It should exclusively deal with matter mentioned in Article 110. It means that there cannot be adulteration. Thoda isme se le liya, thoda ordinary bill, that will not work. Okay, so that's about the definition of money bill. Now, let's see the procedure. Procedure of the money bill, we are only going to see how it is different from the ordinary bill. How it is different from the ordinary bill. Now, we will see that how only new things which are specific to money bill. Money bill ki procedure kahan pe di hai? Although it is not important. Article 109. Okay. Not important at all. Money bill ka article important hai. Okay. Procedure for the money bill. How it is different. So, at introduction stage, what is the thing? At the passing between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, that is Rajya Sabha ki kaisi power hai, President ki kya power hai, and whether the provision of joint sitting is there or any other thing. Okay, so let's see introduction. There are certain specific things related with money bill. First is, it is introduced only in Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha only, that's the first. Second is, it is introduced only with the President recommendation. So President recommendation is must. In case of ordinary bill, we have seen that there is no such thing that was required. Okay, President recommendation is must. It can be only in the Lok Sabha. Third thing is, it is always by the minister. That is, it is a government bill. So money bill, any matter, okay, cannot be, matlab it cannot be a private bill. Private member bill kabhi nahi rahega. It is always by the minister. So therefore, it will be a private bill, a public bill or the government bill. That is the reason if it get defeated, then there is a problem. So introduction mein teen cheez hai. Okay, only in Lok Sabha, only by president, only by minister. Now, since it is coming only first in the Lok Sabha only, okay, so obviously here the second house, whenever we must refer it as a Rajya Sabha. Okay, second house is always Rajya Sabha. Now, what about the deadlock here? Deadlock occurs? No. Rajya Sabha power is limited in case of money bill. Rajya Sabha power is limited. Rajya Sabha power is limited. So, first, they can't reject. They can't amend. They can only propose amendments or recommend amendments. Propose or recommend amendments. They can only propose or recommend amendments. And third is, they can delay or detain by 14 days. So they cannot, here it is not 6 months also. Okay, 14 days. If the 14 days, if the Rajya Sabha is not responding, it is deemed as passed by the House. Okay, do not think that it is deemed as rejection and therefore Lok Sabha single-handedly go ahead with it. Okay, no. Rejection ka unko chance hi nahi hai. They cannot proactively reject. Proactively reject nahi kar sakte. Second is, even if they don't take decision, it is not called as rejection. So the rejection term is not applied at all, okay? It is only called as pending, and 14 days has lapsed, and 14 days has lapsed. The word pending is also not correct. It is deemed as passed, okay? So, ye important hai, they can't amend. ओके अमेंडमेंट जनरली क्या होता है कि लोग एक उसने अमेंड प्रोड्यूस किया तो वो सस्टेंड होना चाहिए. सो दे कैन प्रपोज एंड दैट प्रपोजल वेदर कैन बी एक्सेप्टेड एंड नॉट एक्सेप्टेड बाय द लोकसभा. इफ इट कैन बी एक्सेप्टेड देन ओनली इट कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज अमेंडमेंट, अदरवाइज इट कैन नॉट. सो इट इज बेटर टू कॉल इट दे कैन प्रपोज और रिकमेंड द अमेंडमेंट. Understood? So this is about, now since there is no deadlock because there is no disagreement over the amendment. Amendment will, Lok Sabha, if wish, they will accept. If they don't wish, they don't accept. If they don't accept, it is not called as disagreement. Whatever the wish of Lok Sabha, it will go ahead. Reject nahi hai aur pending 6 months se deadlock ho raha tha. Toh yahan pe pending hai hi nahi hai. Pending 14 days hai only. So it becomes passed. Now come to the president. President power, there are only two options, not three options. There are only two options, either to accept the bill and reject the bill. Also, although he does not reject, but constitutionally speaking, there are two options. Okay, constitutionally speaking, he has a right of absolute vote, although he is not going to use because the government of the day enjoys the majority. But what he do not have is a power of reconsideration. Okay, so the power of reconsideration, that is called as the suspensive veto in case of India. So suspensive veto is not available to the president. We'll see that. Don't use the word suspensive veto. We'll see in case of president power. He has to accept the bill. Agar question aayega, money bill must be accepted by president. Wrong. Although he accepted 100% of the times, but constitutionally speaking, he can reject also. Constitutionally, he has a right of absolute veto. So what he don't have is a reconsideration option here. Joint sitting, not applicable because there is no deadlock. So these are the only things. Okay, do not again, phir se pura padho, phir se ye karo. Itne hi cheeze hain. Theek hai? There is no anything beyond or anything less than this. I hope it's not very difficult to remember. Okay, so this is about the difference in between passing of the money bill and the ordinary bill. Understood? Yes, if you have any issue, please ask. Otherwise, we can move to the next is financial bill, CAT 1 and CAT 2. Financial bill, CAT 1 and CAT 2. How they are being passed and what is their definition? रट्टा मारना है, दो चार बार पढ़ोगे ओके भूल जाता है, फिर से देखना है, फिर से भूल जाना है. ओके, ही विल रिजेक्ट ओनली अंडर द वेरी फ्यू सर्कमस्टेंसेस व्हेन डिसॉल्वड है और नया गवर्नमेंट लाके दिया है. तो रिजेक्ट इज अ रिजेक्ट, बट जनरली इट डज नॉट हैपन दिस वे. इट हैपन्स व्हेन लोकसभा पूरी डिसॉल्व हो जाए, नया गवर्नमेंट आ जाए और नया गवर्नमेंट उनको सजेस्ट कर दे कि बिल मत करो. Yes, now come to the financial bill. In fact, the word financial bill, as I have mentioned, it has three types, that is a money bill, financial bill CAT 1 and financial bill CAT 2. CAT 1, CAT 2, this 110, 117 clause 1 and 117 clause 3. Now first we will see dono simultaneously dekhte hain, financial bill CAT 1 and financial bill CAT 2 iska kya hai. So again we are going to see two things, that is what is the definition, which bill is considered as this, what is the definition of CAT, and then we will see what is the procedure for the passage. ठीक है. Now again we have to compare this with the money bill also, how it is different from money bill at all. ठीक है. Now see here, the financial bill category 1, is something similar to money bill. The matter, here obviously the definition of the wording will be same. The financial bill category one is about the bill which deals with the matter. Which deals with the matter mentioned in Article 110, okay, like that of money bill, but not exclusively 110. 110 plus any other ordinary matter. Matlab, ye thoda sa adulterated money bill hai, theek hai? But it should have a component of money bill. It should have a component of money bill, but it is not exclusively 110. Matlab, half matter mentioned rahega taxation hai, but taxation ke saath aur aisa kuch matter hai jo not a part of 110. Understood? So that's the definition of money bill. So category 1 is defined relatively on the basis of money bill. You have to take a support of definition of money bill. Money bill does not require anybody to define it. It will only 110, 7 points jo mentioned hai. Are you understanding? Okay. So 110 and this thing. Now what about the definition here? Here the definition is some matter which is related with finances. मतलब कहीं ना कहीं पैसे का चीज है, that is a fiscal matter. Fiscal matter or finances. कहीं ना कहीं पैसा spend करने की बात हो रही है, but such finances and matter are not part of 110. इसलिए हम उसको फाइनेंस बिल कह रहे हैं. फाइनेंस बिल इसलिए कह रहे हैं कि बिकॉज some of the other way, some financial aspect is involved, some fiscal matter is involved, but these matters are not part of 110. Understood? I hope point is clear. So yahan pe money bill bhi likhta hu. Tino ki definition bahut clear honi chahiye. Exclusive matter of 110, exclusive matter of 110, 110 plus any other ordinary matter, 110 plus any other matter, and this is something related with money, but nothing is a part of 110. Understood? These three definitions. Okay. So therefore, all see, or ye sabko broad term hai, finance bill. Isko finance bill cat one hi bolna padega. You should not mention just as if it's a finance bill. Finance bill is a very loose term. Finance bill can be money bill also. Finance bill cat one under Article 117 clause 1. Understood these points? Okay. So all money bill can be a finance bill, but all finance bill cannot be money bill, because finance bill can be cat 1 and cat 2 also. Okay. So ab procedures dekhte hai iske upar kya hai. Okay. Procedure mein dekho, ek yaad rakho ki since it has, matlab hint ke liye bata raha hu, there is no rationale for this, since it has a some component of money bill. Okay, तो इंट्रोडक्शन के टाइम में जो भी मनी बिल से रिलेटेड जो टू इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोविजन है, वट आर टू इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोविजन, दैट इज इट विल बी इन द लोकसभा ओनली एंड इट विल बी बाय द रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ प्रेसिडेंट. सो ओनली दिस टू थिंग्स, ये दो चीजें छोड़ के रेस्ट ऑफ द प्रोसीजर इज लाइक ऑर्डिनरी बिल. रेस्ट ऑफ द प्रोसीजर इज लाइक ऑर्डिनरी बिल. Okay, only. So this is the special thing about the, itna hi yaad rakhna hai aapko. That is category one, is it can be produced. Matlab, only the first part, that is Lok Sabha, and it should be recommendation of the president. Passage mein ek chota sa point hai. One point is, whenever amendments are moved with regard to financial bill cat one, and such amendments are, see the thing is that, if you want to reduce the tax, there is never a problem. Okay, reduction of tax. Or if you want to abolish one tax, that's also not a problem, because it is generally considered as in the favor of people. Okay, so reduction of tax or abolition of tax is never a problem. But bill ke passage ke samay apne aisa koi amendment propose kiya hai which increases the taxation, then such amendments require president permission. Okay, that is a yet another significant aspect. पहले तो introduction में ये दो point है, और amendment, okay, that requires an increase in the tax. Such amendments requires permission of president. But if the amendment requires for the decreasing, you don't require. Okay? Understood this part? Okay, that's the only two things which is required. Otherwise, this is just you can remember as it is that common sense logic hai ki agar tax badaoge, okay, to yes, certainly it calls for a serious consideration. Therefore, the president's assent is required. Otherwise, only this much. Now, here, what is the special case in case of procedure or passage of bill? Only one. See, this can be introduced in any house. This can be introduced without even the president assent. So, introduction may, it's like ordinary. There is no specific provision. During the passage of the bill, there is something specific consideration. That during the consideration stage, okay, president, I'll write here. President's recommendation is required by both houses for their consideration. So this is only one single difference. Baki sab like a ordinary bill. So these two bills are more like ordinary bill, except two differences. Okay, for all other purpose, these two are not like money bill. They are like ordinary bill, except here introduction mein ye cheez hai, aur isme passage ke time mein ye cheez hai. Ek hi cheez yaad rakho, ye to amendment aise yaad reh jayega. One special character is during the introduction, that is it has to be Lok Sabha and it has to be president, and one special character during the passage of the bill, that is during the passage, that is during the consideration of each house require a president's recommendation during the consideration stage. Now, how is the deadlock? What about the deadlock? Is the deadlock possible here and there? Is yes or no? Why yes? Because when I am saying it ordinary bill, it means that everything like ordinary bill. Okay, when I say except this one thing, everything is like ordinary, then everything is like, you need not have to question. Joint sitting, yes, joint sitting. What about the power? Is the power of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha equal? Yes, it is equal. 6 month, yes, it is. Can Rajya Sabha amend? Yes, it can amend. So everything that goes with ordinary bill is possible. Can joint sitting possible? Yes, because it is possible for the ordinary bill. So anything that goes with the ordinary bill, that's a part. So financial bill category 1 and category 2, for all practical purpose, they are practical purpose matlab for passage and everything, they are the ordinary bill, except one special case for introduction, there is a special thing, and then there is a passage special thing. Understood? So these are the different types of finance bill. Okay, they are, yes. Yes. No, it cannot be. It will be government. Because taxation matters are generally not proposed by the private members. Yes. Okay? So this is about this constitutional amendment bill we will see separately. Okay, how the passages are constitutional. We have to deal with a separate chapter altogether. We will not create a confusion here. Okay. So this is about the ordinary bill, money bill, and financial bill category 1 and category 2. Okay, constitutional amendment bill we will see later. Now what we are going to see is more confusing, if not constitutional, that is passing of the budget. Okay, how the budget is being passed. Theek hai, bahut sari majorities aa jayenge, lekin I don't think so ki matlab bahut zyada confusion hai, aise hi yaad rakho itne cheez hai. Yes, if you have any doubt, please ask. Yes, cess is obviously, yes, which category it will come. See, the thing is that if it is a matter incidental mein agar rakke wo laya gaya to wo money bill aayega. Otherwise, it will be some money bill ka part. Tax is different from the cess. Okay. This is tax on tax. Swachh Bharat says is a misnomer term. Anybody knows why it is a misnomer and is it a says? नहीं वो नहीं है ठीक है वो मनी वहां पे स्वच्छ भारत के लिए कहां जा रहा है मनी हैज द सीएजी विस्पर्ड इन योर इयर्स कहां पे जा रहा है बता दो हमें सेस का यस सेस किसके ऊपर स्वच्छ भारत का बेस क्या है किसके ऊपर स्वच्छ भारत है कितना परसेंटेज है पॉइंट ओके जो भी पॉइंट परसेंटेज है किसके ऊपर है वो 0.5 ऑन व्हाट हाँ यस यू आर राइट ऑन ऑन होल यस वेरी गुड इट्स नॉट ऑन 14% दैट यू अप्लाई सी द थिंग इज दैट एक 12% है पहले वाला देखते हैं ठीक है सर्विस टैक्स के ऊपर जो सेस लगता था या जो भी है एजुकेशनल सेस है ये है व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सेस सेस इज टैक्स ऑन टैक्स सो देयर इज अ 12% ऑफ टैक्स 12% के ऊपर 0.5% लगता था ठीक है 12% के ऊपर नॉट द ऑन द कॉस्ट द 12% सो देयर इट इज कॉल्ड एज सेस टैक्स ऑन टैक्स बट स्वच्छ भारत सेस इज अ मिसनॉमर बिकॉज स्वच्छ भारत सेस इज नॉट ऑन द टैक्स इट इज ऑन द कंप्लीट 0.5% है वो एक मिसनॉमर करके आपको मतलब लॉलीपॉप दिखाया है वो इट इज एन आई वॉश कि आपको लगेगा कि आप 15% के ऊपर वो पॉइंट जितना भी ऐड कर रहे हो नहीं वो टोटल बेस पूरा है सो टेक्निकली स्पीकिंग नॉट टू करेक्ट टू कॉल सेस एज अ सेस बिकॉज इट इज नॉट टैक्स ऑन टैक्स बेस इज नॉट द 14% टैक्स और उसके ऊपर सेस नहीं लगता है होल के ऊपर लगता है आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग सो दैट बिकम्स अ टैक्स ओनली इट्स नॉट अ सेस तो उसी में आ जाएगा मनी बिल में ठीक है यस एनी अदर क्वेश्चन ओके ऑनलाइन क्वेरी इज देयर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सीज एनीथिंग इन आर्टिकल 13 अरे फिर से उधर चले गए ठीक है आर्टिकल 13 शॉल नॉट अप्लाई टू द बिल पास्ड अंडर द आर्टिकल 368 प्लीज इलाबोरेट अरे कल बहुत इलाबोरेट गया इसके ऊपर फिर भी मैं समझा देता हूँ कैन प्रेसिडेंट विथहोल्ड हिज एसेंट टू द मनी बिल इफ ही cannot reject it. Okay, I'll come to this point also. Yes, tell me for the class. Constitution says anything in Article 13 yesterday. Judicial review ke beech mein humne 13 ke kitne clauses hai? Clause 1, that is a pre-constitutional laws. 13, clause 2, that is a post-constitutional laws. 13.3 is definition of law. And 13.4 is Constitutional amendment will not be a part of law. तो ये पूछ रहे हैं यहाँ पे Constitution says anything in Article 13 shall not apply to the bill passed under the 368. So it means that 368 will not have judicial review for the abolition of for it infringes upon the fundamental rights. But so long as it is not a touching the basic structure, it means that 13 के अंदर ये लिखा हुआ है कि देर इज अ जुडिशियल रिव्यू फॉर ऑल अदर टाइप्स ऑफ बिल्स ऑल अदर टाइप्स ऑफ बिल्स देर विल बी जुडिशियल रिव्यू ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वायोलेशन ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स देर विल बी अ जुडिशियल रिव्यू ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वायोलेशन ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स बट वेन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट बिल इज पास्ड ओके इट विल नॉट कम अंडर द जुडिशियल रिव्यू फॉर द वायोलेशन ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स So long as it is not touching the basic structure. But if court will feel that a particular fundamental right is a basic structure, then certainly they can. ठीक है समझ में आया नहीं आया ओके सो 13 में लिखा तो हुआ है कि constitutional amendment we will not mind even if you will take away the fundamental rights. So constitutional amendment can take away the fundamental rights but cannot touch the basic structure. That's the meaning. Second is can president withhold his assent to the money bill if he cannot reject it? First of all, the word withhold do not get confused. For all practical purpose in Indian constitution, the word withhold is rejection. It is not withholding for some time and then making somebody wait, like pending nahi hai wo. Withhold is equal to rejection in Indian constitution. Okay, it is kept it pending likhega, jo suspend, kaun sa veto hai wo, pocket veto. So pocket veto is where we see that the word withhold is not correct, withhold is rejection. Okay, so in that case, either he can reject or he can accept, that's it. Okay, some more points of precedent power we will see when we will deal with the precedent in detail. I hope ab wo hai bhi nahi yahan pe. I hope it has been answered for him also. Theek hai. Give the feedback to there. Yes, now let's start with the budget. Any other question? Shall we start with the budget? Okay. Aaj koi test nahi hai, toh thoda sa chill out baitho. Okay. Budget. Yes. Where the word budget has been used in Indian Constitution, which article? 112 bola hai kisi ne, 112, okay. Kyunki maine focus shift us liye kiya na ki which article in the constitution mentioned, to sab usme chala gaya. If I would have asked this question, is the budget mentioned in the constitution or not? Haan, tab to no bahut jaldi aa jata. Lekin when I'm saying where it is mentioned in which article, to aa raha. Okay, the word budget is not mentioned in constitution. Okay, the word budget is a very colloquial term, you can say that, non-constitutional. So this is Article 112, and the official name for budget is, yes, Annual Financial Statement. Annual Financial Statement. So this is the constitutional word. And it is in the article, yes, 112. So article, this do not mention the word 112, budget. Now, yes, first of all, let's see what is the definition of annual financial statement or budget. What do you understand by budget? What is a budget? Do not get confused with the money bill. It can be a money bill, where there are so many things within the budget. It's not just about that. Yes? Statement of, yes. That's it. Statement of, yes. Is the statement of revenue and which year? Coming financial year, because there are various things within the budget. Okay, so it's the, and again it's a statement of estimates. It's the estimate. Okay, it is not an what has happened. It is a statement of estimates. Estimates of both. Estimates of receipt and expenditure. For coming financial year. Kabhi ye likh deta hai yahan pe current financial year. To wo miss ho jata hai. It's not a current financial year. Okay? It's a upcoming year. Kyunki ye Feb mein hoga to ye us saal ka nahi hai. Ye jo March ya April 1 se jo chalu hone wala hai. Upcoming year. Issuing. Haan, issuing year. Issuing year is the next year. Current year is... Or bataunga isme kya kya rehta hai aur. But the budget is a statement of, it is an estimate. Okay, it is estimate. The word can be actual also. Ye actual word nahi hai. Theek hai? It's an estimate. Actual matlab already aapne spend kar diya gaya hai. So it's an estimate of receipt and expenditure of issuing year or coming financial year. Not current. Not current. So if 2015-16, if we are giving the budget, then it is a budget of which year? Yes, budget for 2016-17. Matlab, yes, April 2016 to March 2017. Upcoming, issuing, coming. Okay? But yes, it does have 2015, and it does have something about 2014 also. Yes, anybody? Yes, revised estimates and also the estimate of 2015. Okay, jo budget tha. Budget of 2015 and revised estimate of 2015. 2014 ka kya rahega? Rehta hai kuch? 2014 ka actual. Okay, actual statistics of 2014. Itna budget mein rehta hai. Actual matlab pura ka pura ho gaya. Revised matlab abhi revise hi ho raha hai. Abhi actual nahi aaya hai. Pehle estimate rehta hai, phir revised estimate rehta hai, aur phir actual estimate rehta hai. Theek hai? Important nahi hai, but you should mind the words. Okay, it's a estimation. Estimation means yet to be spent both receipt side and expenditure side and of the coming financial year. So that's about the budget. So it means that somewhere you are proposing the tax, because your receipt side is through the tax and non-tax. Receipt matlab, say for example, this is your money or the fund that is you are going to spend in this 1 year. Annual, the word is annual financial statement. Annual financial statement mein aap ek X amount of money ka turnover hai. So money aane ke liye jo bhi bill aap propose karoge, jisko bolte hai receipt side, aur jo money ye hoga wo hai expenditure side. This is receipt side and this is expenditure side. Receipt side mein obviously tax and non-tax. Revenue and non-revenue. That is, revenue will come, the tax expenditure and revenue through the tax and non-tax. Okay, revenue through the tax and non-tax. Ye aapka economics ka part, I am not going in detail. Okay, just aapko thoda sa bata raha hu, kyunki aage word hai, appropriation bill, finance bill, vote on grant and etc. So receipt, paise kahan kahan se aate hai? Two ways, that is a tax and non-tax. Okay, इसमें फिर से और वो capital and current वगैरह है, उतना नहीं जा रहे हम. Okay, tax and non-tax and expenditure plan and non-plan etc. These things are there. Okay, so I hope the point is clear कि क्या-क्या money bill में रहता है. Both, they are going to propose how the money is coming to the government and they are going to propose how the money is being spent. So somebody has said that it is about the government policies. Yes, it reflects the statement of government policies for 1 year. That is taxation policy. What is the tax is coming? Okay, that is about the taxation policy. Expenditure. Okay, that's also, there are different schemes that are to be launched for this particular year. How the money is being spent for this particular year. Those things will be discussed in the, yes, in case of the budget. Yes, now let's see the procedure for the passage. So, money bill ka jo kya kya money bill hai, that's the economics part. Okay, hamare liye matlab polity ke liye what is important is how the budget is being passed. Yes, whose responsibility is there to present the budget? Article 112 kya hai? What is the article 112? Somebody should read. Bear Act kiske paas hai? Haan, padhiye aap. The president shall, okay, finance minister, stand up in the house and speak. The budget speech is given, but it is the responsibility of the president. Yes, padhiye pura statement padhiye.
The president shall, in respect of every financial year, cause to be laid before both the houses of parliament a statement of the estimated receipts and expenditure of the government of India for that year. In this part, referred to as the annual financial statement.
So it is the responsibility of president. Matlab, agar multiple choice mein question aaye, to president, then finance minister, finance secretary, aise options rehte hain. Okay, ultimately budget is presented by, okay, it is presented by finance minister, but it is the responsibility of the constitutional responsibility. It is a constitutional responsibility of the president to ensure that annual financial statement is laid before the house. Okay, something like we have said in case of joint sitting. Okay, summon of joint sitting is president, but presiding is speaker. So here something like that. It's the responsibility of the president to lay it in front of, but ultimately it is being done by? Yes. Contingency fund of India kiske paas rehta hai aur kon spend karta hai? Who holds the contingency fund of India? Contingency bol raha hu. Yes, president, but it is being held by finance secretary. Theek hai, dekhenge hum uske upar special. Yes, so we'll see the budget. Procedure for passage of the budget. Yes, there are in fact two types of budget. What are the two types? Railway. Okay, theek hai. Which committee has suggested that there should be a separate railway budget? Ackworth committee. Okay, 1929, during the time of British, 1929, there is a Ackworth, A-C-W-A-R-T-H, Ackworth committee, who has suggested there should be a budget separate for the railway and for the, yes. Now, when the railway budget is produced?
Last working day of
February. Railway. And when the general? General budget is last working day of Feb. Okay, general budget is last working day of month of February. Last working day of month of February. And railway? Third week of February. Okay, there is no specific, but third week of, prior to budget, but third week of Feb. Obviously by the railway minister. Budget is presented by the finance minister. Okay, finance minister, and finance minister stand before the house in the Lok Sabha. Okay, he presents the budget on the floor of Lok Sabha, which is simultaneously telecasted, or after the end of the speech, it is laid before the Rajya Sabha as well. Okay, it is laid before the, it is called as budget speech. So the word budget speech is given by finance minister. Budget speech is given by the finance minister. He speaks in the Lok Sabha, okay, presents, give the speech. After the end of the speech, the whole budget is laid for the discussion in both houses. Okay, it is laid for the Rajya Sabha also, and it is for the Lok Sabha also. So these are the some of the preliminary things about the budget. Now let us see the procedure for the passing of budget. Okay, procedure for the passing of budget. So what is the budget and what is the procedure for passing? Now something we are going to broadly have, although it has nothing to do with that, but legislative procedure ke saath hi compare karenge hum. Okay, ordinary legislative procedure ya phir money bill. Ordinary mein pehla reading kya tha? Introduction. Matlab yaad rakhne ke liye hum karne wale hai, jaisa aise kuch technically nahi hai. That is, first reading is about introduction. Second is about, second reading mein kya kya tha? General discussion. Then committee stage. And then consideration stage. ठीक है. And third क्या था? Yes, voting. Basically it is voting or passing. Passing the bill as a whole. Okay. So something we will keep the broader framework in mind, and we will see how the budget is passed. Now, introduction of bill mein kya bataya tha? What happens here in? Titles and objectives are read by person only. There is no discussion happen. Discussion matlab koi parliamentarian kuch nahi bolta hai. Okay, that is about. And then publication into the gazette. So this can be, first can be compared with the budget speech. So the first procedure for the passage is budget speech. Budget speech. Budget speech is given by finance minister. Okay, and after the end of the speech, it is laid before both houses. Laid before laid before both houses. Okay. Now, what happens? Second, come to here. Okay, general discussion. So, same thing here also. General discussion on budget. General discussion ऐसे time pass 3-4 दिन करते हैं. कुछ होता नहीं है पर ऐसे. ठीक है. क्योंकि ultimately committee stage important है. Okay, general discussion for 3-4 days. And then this is important. 3-4 days general discussion होने के बाद it will go to the budget will go to the committee stage. Now remember when we say that about the estimation and expenditure है, तो expenditure में estimation proposed है. This proposed is called as demands. Okay, different ministries are demanding कि हमें इतने पैसे चाहिए, इतने पैसे चाहिए, इतने पैसे चाहिए. That is called as demands for grants कि हमें इतना इतना grant चाहिए. So what is happening is the bill is nothing but okay expenditure sides wala is a demands. So various the statement, the financial statement or budget is nothing but a different demands for grants. So this demands for the grants are laid in front of house and now 3-4 days discussed. Now it will go to the scrutiny stage. Scrutiny is done. Wahan pe kaun si committee thi? Select committee or joint committee. Yahan pe committee hai standing committee. Standing committee. Aur yahan pe ek bill nahi hai. Try and understand. This is not a one bill. Jo bhi grant hai, har ministry ki different grant rahegi. To respective ministry ki standing committee. How many standing committees are there? 24. Har ministry ki, har department ki standing committee hai. There are 24 standing committees. So budget mein jo bhi likha hua hai, that is in that particular financial statement, all the demands for the grants will go to the respective ministry, health ministry, finance, etc., etc. So yahan pe, wahan pe keval ek committee, either it was a select committee or a joint committee, but here respective ministries committee will start discussing whether whatever is proposed in the budget, itna itna estimation, really this much of estimate is required or not. So this is a very important stage. Because standing committees mein obviously member of parliamentarians are only there. So this is a close scrutiny of financial proposals that are made in the budget. Are you understanding? This is also for the mains perspective. This is the parliament's control, financial control on the executives. Okay, how does it reflect? It reflects the parliamentarians' control on the executives. Because in the standing committee, all the political parties will get a proportional representation, and in different committees they are trying to discuss, deliberate, scrutinize whether the demand. So each standing committee will make a report for their particular ministry ki ye demand sahi hai ya galat hai, aur wo report fir se wapas aa jayega. Are you understanding? General discussion ho gaya, general discussion ke baad committee ke paas chala gaya, committee ke baad fir se हाउसेस में वापस आ गया, दोनों हाउस में वापस आ गया. देखो यहाँ पे दोनों साइमल्टेनियसली चल रहा है, इट इज नॉट पहले राज्यसभा और फिर, दोनों में साइमल्टेनियसली चल रहा है. नाउ नेचुरली यहाँ पे क्या था, कंसिडरेशन स्टेज. कंसिडरेशन स्टेज में क्या हो रहा था, क्लॉज बाय क्लॉज वोटिंग हो रही है. तो यहाँ पे स्टैंडिंग कमिटी का रिपोर्ट आने के बाद, अब यहाँ पे क्लॉज मतलब क्या है, दैट इज अ डिमांड फॉर ग्रांट. सो देर इज अ वोटिंग ऑन डिमांड फॉर ग्रांट्स. इसका कुछ ना कुछ करना पड़ेगा, वो मतलब इतने डिमांड किए है. सी रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, ऑल द डिमांड्स व्हेन गेट वोटेड, ओके पॉजिटिवली वोटेड, इट कन्वर्ट इनटू ग्रांट्स. पहले इनको केवल डिमांड बोला जाता है. व्हेन दे आर एक्सेप्टेड पॉजिटिवली और वोटेड पॉजिटिवली, दे बिकम्स योर ग्रांट. इट मीन्स दैट whatever you have estimated, parliament has approved that whatever the demand was there, that much will be now available to you. Okay, it is a positive assertion on part of the legislature that your demand, what you have proposed, that much you will get. So demand will convert into the grants. Now, one or two things here you should remember, at least two things. Rajya Sabha cannot vote. Rajya Sabha cannot vote on demand for grant. Okay, it is the only prerogative of Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha only can discuss. Rajya Sabha only discuss. They cannot vote. Rajya Sabha only can discuss. That is the one thing. So who is going to vote only? Lok Sabha. Again, second thing, remember, the whole demand for grants are not voted. Something which is charged upon Consolidation Fund of India, that cannot be voted. Okay, even the Lok Sabha cannot vote it. So something which is charged, something which is, if this word is there for some, jitna bhi expenditure likha hoga, usme likha hoga ki this is charged upon Consolidation Fund of India. So something which is charged upon Consolidation Fund of India, even nobody can vote, not voted. Not voted, not even by the Lok Sabha. Okay? So these two things you should remember. Is there any doubt? Are you understanding? Yahan pe proposal tha, thoda sa general discussion ho gaya, committee member, committee has scrutinized, committee has given the report. Now it is for the member of legislature to consider whether whatever has been proposed, should we give a chance to the government to convert that demands into grants or not. So obviously voting is required, but such voting cannot be done in Rajya Sabha. It is done only in case of Lok Sabha. So demand for grants are voted in case of Lok Sabha only. But Rajya Sabha can discuss. They can discuss the things, they cannot vote. Second is, even if the voting is happening, it will not be on the something which is charged upon Consolidation Fund of India. It is for the rest of the other grants. These two things you should remember, you should not forget. Second thing is, now, what opposition will do? Okay, unko to dena hi nahi hai na. Matlab sab demands grant, kuch na kuch to matlab dikhana chahiye ki hum bhi kuch hai. To seedhe, if the demand ki inko kam karni hai, ab ye grant to pura nahi kar sakte kyunki majority nahi hai, they will try to reduce the demand, iski price kam ho jaye. To iske liye cut motions rehte hain. We'll see that, what is cut motion. So opposition generally resort to what is known as cut motions. They will try to reduce the amount of demands that are mentioned in, yes, proposals. Everybody is following me. Kya ho raha hai? Samajh mein aa raha hai? Nahi aa raha hai? Hawa lag rahi hai ya kya ho raha hai? Lag rahi hai na? Theek hai. So opposition will try to see the government would want every demand should get converted into grant. Opposition will want every demand, it should be reduced as maximum as possible. Jitna paisa kam inko spend karne diya jaye, utna kam hai. So they will bring what is known as cut motion. So definition of cut motion is, cut motions are motions which are moved in order to reduce the demands. Cut motions are the different motions which are moved in order to reduce the demands. Reduce matlab reduce bhi, abolish bhi. So there are three types of cut motions. This is again a very favorite area for prelims. Okay, there are three types of cut motions. First is called as policy cut. Second is called as economy cut. And third is token cut. Policy cut, economy cut, and token cut. Now, bahut zyada matlab don't bank your head matlab ratta marne ke liye. Theek hai? Try to understand the vocabulary. Usse hi yaad reh jayega. Theek hai? पॉलिसी कट मतलब ऑपोजिशन को चाहिए कि पूरी पॉलिसी खराब है आपकी. द होल पॉलिसी इज रॉन्ग. दे आर वेरी डिसअपॉइंटेड विद द पॉलिसी. सो दे वॉन्ट टू कंप्लीटली रिमूव अ पर्टिकुलर डिमांड. सो पॉलिसी कट शोज दैट कंप्लीट रिजेक्शन, कंप्लीट डिलीशन ऑफ डिमांड और रिजेक्शन. इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द कंप्लीट रिजेक्शन. मतलब उनको चाहिए कि कोई एक डिमांड है, उस डिमांड को हटा ही दो पूरा, पैसे मत कम करो उसको. सो जनरली मोशन जो मूव किया जाता है तो उसके द सम शुड बी रिड्यूस टू रुपीज वन. मतलब सिंबॉलिक है ऑब्वियसली, एक रुपए क्या तो स्पेंड करोगे आप. ओके, इट शोज दैट द अपोजिशन इज कंप्लीटली. सो मोशन इज मूड. मोशन इज मूड ये भी पूछते हैं. मतलब मोशन इज मूड टू कन्वर्ट द अमाउंट दैट इज टू बी स्पेंड टू रुपीज वन. तो एक मोशन मूव करेंगे कि इस पॉलिसी के रुपए हम एक रुपए आपको देंगे. हाँ, एक रुपए देंगे, इसका मतलब है कि दिस इज अ पॉलिसी कट. ओके, देर इज अ कंप्लीट रिजेक्शन. सो कंप्लीट पॉलिसी इज रॉन्ग. इकोनॉमिक कट, हमें लग रहा है कि पैसे आप ज्यादा स्पेंड कर रहे हो. सो वी आर नॉट अनहैप्पी विथ योर पॉलिसी. पॉलिसी इज फाइन, योर डिमांड इज फाइन, बट द अमाउंट यू आर आस्किंग फॉर इज टू मच. So we will not reduce, completely reject the policy, we will reduce specific amount. Okay? So isme kya hai, complete rejection of policy nahi hai, that is economic cut. Economic cut, that is a specific sum is reduced. Specific amount is to be reduced. Specific amount. This is in order to bring the economy टू पॉलिसी. इकोनॉमी मतलब एफिशियंसी टू पॉलिसी. दिस इज कंप्लीटली रिजेक्शन ऑफ पॉलिसी. दिस इज टू ब्रिंग अबाउट इकोनॉमी टू पॉलिसी. इकोनॉमी मीन्स आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग एफिशियंसी टू पॉलिसी. और इतना ही लगेगा उसको, ज़्यादा पैसे नहीं चाहिए. तो दे विल रिमूव विद द स्पेसिफिक अमाउंट. दैट इज कॉल्ड एस इकोनॉमी कट. टोकन कट, द वर्ड टोकन मतलब क्या है, सिम्बॉलिक कट. सिम्बॉलिक कट में आपकी पॉलिसी भी फाइन है और आपके पैसे भी फाइन है. But since we are opposition, we will not be very happy with you. So these are the specific grievances, okay, to ventilate. Hai na, emotions ko vent kar dena, okay? To ventilate specific grievances. Specific grievances against government. This is only symbolic. So therefore, amount will reduce by rupees 10 or 1 hai 100 ha by rupees 100 matlab hum by, see this word is also important, we will reduce by rupees 100 and we will reduce to 1. So 500 crore has been proposed for something, we will reduce 100 rupees out of it. So 100 rupees matlab this is symbolic, that's why it is called as token cut. Okay, so this is very important. Three different cut motions in order to reduce the demand. Now see, the significance of it is practically not much, because these motions are not being passed. These motions are not passed because opposition do not enjoy the majority. So actually they don't get passed, but at least if they move the motion, there is a discussion on it, ki whether we require to reduce it or not. So there will be a more discussion, there will be a more scrutiny, there will be more rationalization on that particular demand. So that demand will be discussed, debated, scrutinized. This also a sort of a legislature control, financial control on the executive. Okay, so when the committee stage mein yahan pe aa raha hai, toh simultaneously two things are there. One is opposition will first try to go through the cut motion. But ultimately, ये इनका सब पूरा ड्रामा होने हो जाने के बाद में it will be put to the vote. Finally, it is putting for the vote and then voting happens. That is a demand for the grants are voted to convert demands into grants. इनके पास इतना time नहीं रहता है कि हर एक demands को इसको scrutinize किया जाएगा. So at the end of the time, say for example, generally 109 proposed रहते हैं demands, मतलब ये number fix है. So 109 के से फॉर एग्जाम्पल डिमांड फॉर ग्रांट जो है उन्होंने 30 डिस्कस कर लिया, ठीक है, तो 70 प्लस 9, 79 आर नॉट डिस्कस्ड. तो एंड डे, लास्ट डे में एवरीथिंग इज पुट ऑन द वोट, इवन इफ देर इज नो डिस्कशन. ओके, एंड दे आर पुट इनटू द वोट, एंड इवन विदाउट डिस्कशन दे विल बी गेट पास. दिस प्रोसीजर इज कॉल्ड एज गुलिटाइन. व्हाट इज दिस वर्ड? यस, फ्रेंच रिवोल्यूशन में. व्हाट वाज इट? रॉबेस्पेरी. हाँ, रॉबेस्पेरी. ओके, दैट इज अबाउट जोकोबियंस. सो जोकोबियंस वेर एक्सट्रीमिस्ट. ओके, एंड दे यूज टू किल द पीपल विद द, यस, द ब्लेड, दैट गिलिटोन ब्लेड. So the one who is criticizing the Jacobians, so, or the this sort of a extreme form of French Revolution, okay, they have been eliminated. Thermidarian reaction, jisko bola jata hai. Okay, so that's a sort of a thing. If you discuss, don't discuss, we will chop and we will just finish it off. Okay, no discussion required. This is a one of the, agar kahi essay aa jata hai, functioning of democracy, functioning of parliamentary democracy. So this is very important point to be discussed. Ki there are so many adjournments, there is no substantive discussion, there are most of the times opposition is not a constructive opposition, lot of time is getting wasted, and since lot of time is getting wasted, some of the things are not discussed, and finally they are put on the vote without any discussion, and therefore this is a very undemocratic. Ki jo demand hai wo discuss hi nahi hui hai floor of the house, but since the time has finished, you will put everything on the voting. Okay, so that's about the guillotine. And once the demand is being passed, so demands got converted into grants. Okay, now remember one thing, charged upon consolidation fund are not voted. Okay, wo waise ke waise hi pass ho jaye, uske upar koi matlab challenge nahi rehta hai. Why, what is the matter within the charge upon consolidation fund? Why there is no discussion? Why there is no question mark? Yes, these are basically, say for example, salaries of Supreme Court and High Court. So, unki independence maintain karne ke liye, okay, in order to maintain their independence, ki unki salary parliamentarians nahi kam karenge. Nahi to wahan pe Supreme Court ka koi decision aaya, yahan pe inki salary kam kar di. Okay, haan, 50 rupay kaat diya, 100 rupay kaat diya. So, it will hamper the autonomy and integrity. So in order to maintain the autonomy and integrity, and in some areas, it's already accepted that this much of money is required to spend for the day-to-day business, jo bhi hai. Toh uske liye ye ek hai. Theek hai? Understood this part? Now we are coming to two more parts, that is the appropriation bill and... I'll just again write it. Appropriation bill and finance bill. See, when the budget is there, obviously there is a whatever the fund or money is there, consolidation fund of India, some money is coming in and some money is moving out. Now how much money to be moved out to be, or how much money is to be extracted, how much, this is decided by grants. Okay, ye decide hua hai khali, demands have got converted into grants. But ye jo grant matlab isme kya hua hai, amount has been decided that this much of money you can withdraw. Okay, it has not given the authority to withdraw the money. It has only decided the how much amount money should be withdrawn. Okay, so isme grants mein dono cheeze aa jayegi, that is a normal grant plus isme charged upon consolidation fund of India. Ye jo voted part tha, and this was a non-voted part, but yes, finally you will remove this also. Grants and charge upon consolidation fund of India. So this, in dono ka sum total of money, you got an authority to remove it. But finally, remove karne ke liye aapko special ek bill lana padega. Okay, that is appropriation bill. Appropriation bill. So just don't get confused with this. This was just your estimate mentioned in the budget. Estimate, nothing but there are certain demands, and these demands got converted into grants. It means that you got an approval that this X amount of money you can now take away. But only amount has been decided, not authority for the removal. यहाँ पे एक स्टेटमेंट लिखो, मतलब ये काम की बहुत स्टेटमेंट है, कई बार आती है, दैट मनी के नॉट बी विथड्रॉवन, नो मनी कैन बी विथड्रॉन आउट ऑफ कंसोलिडेशन फंड ऑफ इंडिया एक्सेप्ट by law, except by law, okay? So this means that even if the money is approved for withdrawal, you require an approval by law. So even a single penny, if you want to remove out of Consolidation Fund of India, you require an approval of law. Again, remember, this is not except by executive niyam, okay? So this also shows that it is the parliament which controls the withdrawal of money from the Consolidation Fund of India. It's not executive, it's the parliament. Once parliament will approve it, then it gives an opportunity for executives to do it. How it is done? It is through the appropriation bill. Ye statement constitution mein likha hua hai ki aap law laake hi, only when if you will bring the law, then you can withdraw the money. And since we have to withdraw the money, we have to bring the law, and this law is called as appropriation law or appropriation act. Ye pehle bill rehta hai and it get converted into act. Understood? So budget jab pass ho raha hai, tab kya kya cheeze pass ho rahi hai dekho. Pehle to budget speech ho gayi, okay? Then uske baad kya hua tha? General discussion ke baad standing committee, and standing committee ke baad then do cheeze hui thi, voting on demand for grant and cut motion. Ab next cheez aa gayi, that is passing of appropriation bill, appropriation act or appropriation bill, and then there will be a passing of finance bill, because appropriation bill is a withdrawal site. Ye withdrawal site hai, ye jo fund andar aa raha hai, that is a tax and बोरोइंग, जो भी आपका प्रपोजल है, इसके लिए कौन सा बिल रहेगा? फाइनेंस बिल. सो दीज आर द टू इंपॉर्टेंट बिल्स. डिमांड फॉर ग्रांट इज नॉट बिल. डिमांड फॉर ग्रांट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ बजट एस्टिमेट दैट हैज बीन कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्रांट. ओके, मनी विड्रॉ करना है तो ये है, और मनी अंदर लाना है तो ये बिल है. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड एज अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल एंड द फाइनेंस बिल रिस्पेक्टिवली. आफ्टर voting on demand for grant, appropriation bill and the finance bill are taken. After passage of both of them, one can see that there is a completion of procedure of passage of budget. Okay, so budget broadly involves passing of three things, that is voting on demand for grant, second, passing of appropriation bill, and third is passing of finance bill. Understood? One is voting for demand for grant means estimation is getting converted into grants. Second is appropriation bill, which gives you the authority for the withdrawal of bill, and finance bill on the receipt side. Now, in case of appropriation bill, okay, the whole procedure is similar, okay, as that of the budget bill, because we have seen this is a part of the budget. Budget ke ek definition mein dikha tha, ek appropriation matter tha, 110 mein. The only thing you should remember here is, once appropriation bill is tabled, okay, then you cannot move any amendments. Because essentially appropriation bill mein do kaun se part hai, jo grant aapne already voting ho chuki hai. Demand is already got converted into grant. The legislature has accepted itna itna money hai. Plus, charged upon Consolidation Fund of India. To aap kya amendment laoge isme? Logically hai, you cannot now change the destination of grant. Amendment lana iska matlab kya hua? Are you changing the destination of grant? you are changing the amount of grant, you are changing the purpose of grant, which you have already done when demand for grant are being voted. Are you understanding? So therefore, there cannot be any change in the destination of grant. There cannot be change in reduction of charge upon. वो तो पहले ही नहीं हो रहा था. तो appropriation bill is simply put in order to tell the this parliamentarians that it is nothing but an authority for the executive to withdraw the money which has been the sum total of 2. Understood? So that is the passage of the bill. Okay, this passage of the bill. Procedure and everything will be same as that of the money bill. Finance bill, same thing. This is only on the receipt side. Receipt side mein kya rehta hai? Tax proposal rehte hai. Okay, government is proposing the different tax proposals. Is tax mein kabhi slab change kar diya, kabhi ye kar diya, wo kar diya, theek hai. So whatever tax proposal is there, that is a part of finance bill. Now isme bhi aap इसमें आप अमेंडमेंट ला सकते हो, लेकिन वही है जो लॉजिक बताया था आपको. यू कैन रिड्यूस द टैक्स, यू कैन रिमूव द टैक्स, बट यू कैन नॉट ब्रिंग द अमेंडमेंट टू इंक्रीज द टैक्स विच हैज बीन प्रपोज्ड. मतलब प्रपोजल करके आप इंक्रीज करके ला सकते हो. मतलब गवर्नमेंट पहले ड्राफ्ट करते समय सोचेगा कि हमें टैक्स इंक्रीज करना है. सिर्फ फॉर एग्जाम्पल 30% टैक्स है, 30% का उन्होंने 35% कर लिया. They can increase at the time of proposal, but 35 होके फिर amendment करके फिर 36 नहीं करेंगे वो. ठीक है, whatever they have to propose, they can propose. But yes, 35 का 30 हो सकता है, 25 हो सकता है, it can be abolished altogether. एक हाथ है कि fringe benefit tax abolish करना है, abolish कर सकते हैं. So यहाँ पे amendment में क्या है? Yes, you can bring the amendment so long as you are reducing the tax or you are abolishing the tax. But you cannot bring the amendment for increasing the tax. Appropriation bill mein amendments, no amendments, because you have already done lot of things before. You are just finally now telling that you got an authority to withdraw the money. Okay? So everything get passed, and therefore it requires at least 2 months. The whole process of budget. Budget has started on the last day of February. So matlab March ka starting. So March pula chala jata hai and April full chala jata hai. When the financial year start? 1st of April. So 1st of April, April chala gaya, aur phir May end. Sorry, March. February end mein wo ho gaya, theek hai? So February end ke baad 2 mahine lagte hain. To 2 mahine unko paise lagenge. See, the thing is that yahan pe kya likha hua hai? No money can be withdrawal except by the law. It means that unless and until appropriation bill is passed, you cannot withdraw a single penny out of the consolidation fund. Now, how much time you require to pass the bill? 2 months. So what about the 2 months where the money is required? Yes. So there, yes. Are you understanding? Say the in the month of March, you are starting the process of budget. This says that you cannot withdraw the money unless and until appropriation bill is passed. So full month March ka pass ho gaya and full month of April pass ho gaya. Okay, so these are generally the 2 months which has been lapsed. Yahan pe kahin jaake aapka appropriation bill pass hua hai. So what about 2 months from where the money should be extracted? So for this particular purpose, okay, pending the passage of appropriation bill, convention has already developed. On the day, मतलब जैसे ही budget speech pass हो गई और general discussion, so general discussion के बाद एक process की जाती है, that is called as vote on account. This is very important. Many a times this is asked. Okay, what is vote on account? Vote on account is generally the money what is required for 2 months. Okay, that much of money is approved and the mandate is given to the executive that they can use this money. So generally ये money कितना amount रहता है 2 months के लिए. हाँ, 2 months के लिए. So 12 months का जितना भी money propose रहेगा तो 1/16 रहेगा. Okay, 12 divided by 2 आप करोगे तो उसका कितना आ जाएगा 1/16. Okay, so 1/16 yes. हाँ, 6, because see 2 months के लिए आपको जितना मनी मतलब आपने एनुअल फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट में जो भी फिगर मेंशन किया है सो जो भी फिगर मेंशन है उसका 1/6 पार्ट फॉर द 2 मंथ्स दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड ठीक है सो दिस इज नॉट डिबेटेड डिस्कस्ड नथिंग इज डन बिकॉज वन कैन सेफली अंडरस्टैंड कि 2 मंथ्स के लिए पैसे लगेंगे सो दीज वोट ऑन अकाउंट इज नथिंग बट द मनी ओके विच हैज बीन अप्रूव्ड फॉर पेंडिंग द passage of appropriation bill the government will require certain money for the 2 months which is passed ye vote on account general discussion matlab jaise speech khatam ho gayi 2-3 din mein matlab even before the standing committee ke liye ja raha hai standing committee time legi uske pehle matlab speech ke baad kya tha general discussion ke baad standing committee so general discussion mein hi ek chhota sa motion डाल दिया जाता है दैट इज वोट ऑन अकाउंट उसके ऊपर कोई मतलब डिबेट डिस्कशन नहीं होता है इट इज अ वेरी नॉर्मल प्रोसेस बट यस द मनी इज रिक्वायर्ड पेंडिंग दैट वर्ड इज इंपॉर्टेंट व्हाई इट इज गिवन पेंडिंग द अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल अल्टीमेटली अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल विल गिव यू द अथॉरिटी दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वोट ऑन अकाउंट अंडरस्टूड दिस पार्ट ओके सो दैट्स अबाउट इट जस्ट वी विल सी द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फंड ओके 4-5 फंड है वो देख लेंगे हाँ इंटरिम बजट भी देखेंगे इंटरिम बजट एंड कंसोलिडेशन ये ऐसे वोट ऑन अकाउंट वोट ऑन क्रेडिट एक्सेप्शनल ग्रांट्स एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा दीज आर द थिंग आई होप एटलीस्ट इतना समझ में आ गया ओके ऑर्डिनरी बिल मनी बिल फाइनेंस बिल बजट ओके ऑल ऑफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड इसको बार बार पढ़ना पड़ेगा आपको मतलब इट्स नॉट दैट इट्स अ वेरी वोलाटाइल हियर देर इज ओनली अटेम्प्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड कि विच क्वेश्चंस एंड व्हाट आर द नुएंसेस दैट यू रिक्वायर टू पे अटेंशन टू दैट इज इट ओके सो यू हैव टू रिवाइज इट अगेन एंड फॉर वट एवर आई एम डूइंग हियर आई कैन से मतलब कि इसके बियॉन्ड तो नहीं पूछे थे ठीक है सो दिस मच यू कैन डू एंड साइमल्टेनियसली यू कैन रीड लक्ष्मीकांत ओके इसके बियॉन्ड रिक्वायर्ड भी नहीं है ओके एंड इफ यू सी द लास्ट ईयर्स पेपर्स नेवर एनीथिंग लाइक मतलब बियॉन्ड दिस इज बीइंग आस्क्ड ठीक है रिपीटेडली उसी एरियाज से क्वेश्चन आते हैं जैसे ज्वाइंट कमेटी का भी बोला था ये भी पूछा हुआ था जो अभी बता रहा था राज्यसभा के नॉट वोट राज्यसभा कैन ओनली डिस्कस ये क्वेश्चन लास्ट ईयर आया हुआ है ठीक है तो दीज आर द एस्पेक्ट्स आई विल जस्ट राइट डाउन सम ऑफ द नेम्स लाइक दिस is something called as additional grant ye bas term yaad rakho ab first is supplementary grant supplementary grant additional grant excess grant then वोट ऑन अकाउंट एक एक लाइन याद करना है बस इसका वोट ऑन क्रेडिट एंड एक्सेप्शनल ग्रांट लास्ट इज टोकन ग्रांट This is Article 115, Article 116, not at all required to be remembered. ठीक है Supplementary grant, additional grant and token grant. There are also two terms. Once it has been asked, one is called as rule of lapse. What is doctrine of lapse? हाँ मध्य प्रदेश में मत चले जाइए क्या था मध्य प्रदेश में वाला डलहौसी हाँ डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स वो हाँ कौन सी रानी थी वो झांसी की रानी हाँ सो डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स वो हिस्ट्री वाली लैप्स है ये दूसरा लैप्स है रूल ऑफ लैप्स और दूसरा टर्म क्या रहेगा फिर यहाँ पे मार्च रश ये पूछा है एक बार मार्च रश rule of labs. Okay, we will discuss that later. Okay, so these are the some of the funky terms which are there, okay, in order to unsettle us. But again, see, the thing is that if you remember the vocabulary terms, okay, it's self-explanatory, all of them. Okay, all of them are self-explanatory. See, one is budget kya kar raha hai, ek normal grants to tumhe de hi raha hai. Ye normal grants chhod ke, baki ke kuch ek grants hai, jisko kaha jata hai, extraordinary grants. Okay, ye grants kahan pe aa jayega? Ye to apna grants ho gaya, appropriation bill ke andar ahi aa gaya. Appropriation bill ka kaun sa article hai? 114. Again, not required to be remembered, but likh raha hu isse. Okay, kyunki appropriation bill ke normal grants and extraordinary grants 115 and 116. Now normal grants ho gaye, itna itna bill itne itne minister ko ministry ko is baat ke liye mil raha hai, for a particular ministry, for a particular function and for particular activity. Okay, the earmarking has already happened, authority has already done. Now, even after doing this, there is always a problem which can crop up, and to address such issues, we have different variants. Now, first, let's understand what is in supplementary, okay, and what is in additional, and what is in exceptional. Supplementary is to supplement. To supplement, matlab supplement kab karna padega? Jo bhi grant hai aapne accept kiya, that becomes insufficient. That becomes insufficient. So, ek A prakar ki service thi. A service ke liye aapne 100 crores bataye the. But abhi lag rahe ki 110 crores. So, the money which was proposed by ordinarily was not sufficient, or it was insufficient. Therefore, we have to supplement. So, supplementary grant is given when money is insufficient for a particular service. Okay, when the money is insufficient for a particular service. You have already proposed something for that service, but that much of amount was not sufficient. So, I think a self-explanatory is supplementary. Supplementary is always with respect to something. Okay, jo supplement lete hain hum exam mein, abhi UPSC ne utne mein hi likh do bol diya hai. Nahi to pehle to log aise aadhe ghante mein utke dusron ko peer pressure create karte the. और ये क्या इतने क्या लिखा है इसने, कुछ भी नहीं, ब्लैंक छोड़ के सप्लीमेंट्री ले लेते. ठीक है, सच थिंग्स डज नॉट हैपन. अभी सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट्स सप्लीमेंट के लिए, एडिशनल ग्रांट्स, द वर्ड इज हियर एड. ओके, समथिंग विच इज न्यू, एडिशनल थिंग इज कमिंग. इट मीन्स दैट ए सर्विस थी, लेकिन आपने कुछ ए डैश काम किया है. ओके, विच हैज नॉट बीन प्रपोज अर्लियर, समथिंग विच इज न्यू विच यू हैव प्रपोज. सो देयरफॉर व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इज एडिशनल. You have add-on, एक कोई service थी. यहाँ पर क्या हुआ, उसी service को implement करने के लिए आपने पैसे खर्च किए थे, यहाँ पर उस service को छोड़ के और थोड़ा कुछ और खर्च कर रहे हो. So this is a new service which was not proposed earlier, which was not proposed earlier. For that new service some money is required, that is called as additional. Supplementary and additional. Supplementary for the same, additional for the new. Excess. Now this is important, it is slightly different. Excess matlab ek service thi, yahan pe to aapne manga nahi, apne aap se hi aapne ek excess money spent kar diya. Already you have done it. Excess money has been spent, aise yaad rakho. Excess money has already been spent. To 100 crore approve kiya tha, lekin aapne ground level ke upar hi waise hi 100 crore ki jagah 110 crore spent kar diya. Money has already spent. Now, वो जो 10 करोड़ है उसका अप्रूवल बाद में, पोस्ट स्पेंट अप्रूवल मांग रहे हो. दैट इज एक्सेस मनी हैज बीन स्पेंट, देयरफॉर वी वांट अ अप्रूवल ऑफ 10 करोड़ रुपीस. इन दिस टू आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग, इट इज टू बी प्रपोज, यू हैव नॉट स्पेंट, यू आर आस्किंग दैट इट इज इनसफिशियंट, देयरफॉर प्लीज गिव अस सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट एंड एडिशनल ग्रांट. इन एक्सेस ग्रांट यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन इट एंड यू आर यस री अप्रूवल उसका ले रहे हो. खुद के जेब में से तो कोई नहीं डालेगा. ठीक है, आज सिविल सर्विस डे है, पीपल आर वेरी इंस्पायर्ड, मतलब स्टेटस अपडेट कर रहे हैं कि ऐसे करूँगा, वैसे करूँगा, ये करूँगा. ठीक है, ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम सिंपल एक वो करो कि लास्ट ये चार महीने में रोज 6 घंटे पढ़ाई करूंगा सो दैट आई विल एंटर इन सिविल सर्विसेज. ठीक है, उतना ही गुड इनफ है. तो बाद में आप, हाँ, फिर जो भी आपके ड्रीम्स है. ठीक है, सो मेक अ फर्स्ट स्टेप, बेबी स्टेप की टू एंटर इनसाइड एंड बिफोर दैट स्टार्ट डूइंग अ हार्ड वर्क. ओके, बहुत स्कैथिंग रिमार्क नहीं था, डोंट टेक इट मतलब इतना पर्सनली. ठीक है, समझ में आया. एक्सेस इज ऑलरेडी स्पेंड. नाउ दिस इज अबाउट दिस 3 सप्लीमेंट्री एडिशनल एंड दिस वोट ऑन अकाउंट. व्हाट इज वोट ऑन अकाउंट? हैव यू हर्ड ऑफ इट एनीवेयर? कब? अभी वही है, इधर से आया तो मतलब ऐसे नहीं है कि डबल लिख दिया तो ये यहां पे कोई है. वोट ऑन अकाउंट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, दैट इज 2 मंथ पेंडिंग द पासिंग ऑफ द अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल. 2 मंथ्स के लिए कुछ ना कुछ मनी स्पेंड करने के लिए एग्जीक्यूटिव को देना पड़ता है. दैट इज अ 1/6 अमाउंट. इफ द क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड 1/6 अमाउंट, इट्स नॉट करेक्ट. जनरली 1/6 रहता है वो. ओके, इट्स नॉट फिक्स्ड 1/6. इट विल बी फिक्स्ड बाय द पार्लियामेंट. ईच टाइम इट कैन बी 1/6, 1/5, 1/7 ऐसे रहता है. बट जनरली क्या होता है कि लॉजिक है, 2 महीने बिल पैसेज को लगेगा तो 6 मंथ का 1/6 इज 2 मंथ्स. ओके, सो वॉट एवर द मनी दैट इज नॉट डिस्कस्ड, डिबेटेड, डायरेक्टली अप्रूव्ड बाय द लेजिस्लेचर. ओके, सो दैट द एग्जीक्यूटिव कैन स्पेंड द मनी पेंडिंग द पासिंग ऑफ अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वोट ऑन अकाउंट. वोट ऑन क्रेडिट, क्रेडिट ऐसे याद रखो. क्रेडिट किस लिए देते हैं? ओके, क्रेडिट कार्ड्स कि आपके पैसे, हाँ, जो चाहे मन चाहे कहीं पे भी कुछ भी किसी भी टाइम खरीद सकते हो. सो इट्स द सेम थिंग. द वोट ऑन क्रेडिट इज फॉर अनफोर्सीन सर्कमस्टेंसेस, अनफोर्सीन, अनप्रेडिक्टेबल, अनप्रेडिक्टेबल ओके केसेस के लिए दिया जाता है. इनडेफिनेट, जिसका इनडेफिनेट, इनडेफिनेट मतलब उसकी कॉस्ट लिखी नहीं जा सकती कि इसको 100 रुपए लगेंगे, 1000 रुपए लगेंगे. इट कैन बी एनीथिंग. सो इट्स अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ ब्लैंक चेक गिवन बाय द लेजिस्लेचर टू द एग्जीक्यूटिव. सो टुडे एनीथिंग कैन इमर्ज वेयर द गवर्नमेंट रिक्वायर्स टू स्पेंड द मनी. सो सम मनी इज ईयर मार्क्ड कॉल्ड एज वोट ऑन क्रेडिट. ये आपका क्रेडिट है. इसके आगे हम ये नहीं लिख रहे कि ये जूते के लिए, ये इसके लिए, ये है. आपकी मर्जी, चाहे कॉस्मेटिक के ऊपर डाल दो या किसी के ऊपर डाल दो, स्वच्छ भारत पे डाल दो. ठीक है, एनीथिंग यू कैन डू इट. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वोट ऑन क्रेडिट. सो रिमेंबर द 2 कीवर्ड्स हियर इज अनप्रेडिक्टेबल एंड इनडेफिनेट कैरेक्टर विच cannot be codified, okay? And for that purpose, the vote on credit is given. Exceptional grant, exceptional grant for the exceptional circumstances, okay? Some exceptional circumstances, special circumstances लिखा जाता है इसको. अब ये पता नहीं है कि यहाँ पे और यहाँ में difference क्या है. Special circumstances, ऐसे याद रखो. Exceptional, special. Some special circumstances, the money is been earmarked. Only thing difference here is special circumstances do not form a part of any account. Okay, so it's just the legislature gives the money. That is the exceptional circumstances. Last is about token grant. So yahan pe article ye khatam ho jata hai. Token grant is just a term. Remember that not a single money additionally is given. The word is again token. I'll explain that what happens. So for example, for A service you have already is grant ke andar 100 crore approved kiya tha. For B you have approved 50 crore. Now what has happened? Aapko ground level pe pata chala ki B ko 50 crore nahi, B ko 75 crore required hai. Theek hai? Aur 100 crore A ko iska kaam chal ja raha hai 75 crore mein. सो इट मीन्स दैट ये जो यहाँ पे कितना बच गया 25, यहाँ पे कितना लगना था 25. सो देर इज अ री अप्रोप्रिएशन हैपनिंग. नो न्यू फंड इज गिवन, ओनली द हेड ऑफ फंड इज ट्रांसफर्ड. ऐसे करेंगे यहाँ की 25 करोड़ इज ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम ए टू बी. सो फॉर अ बी यू आर नॉट गेटिंग री अप्रोप्रिएशन, जस्ट राइट हियर टोकन ग्रांट. अंडर द टोकन ग्रांट there is a reappropriation of, under the token grant there is a reappropriation of fund or a grant happens, there is a reappropriation of grant happen. There is no proposal of new fund. There is no proposal of new fund. New or additional or excess fund nahi diya jata hai. It's only the reappropriation, mutual. Kahin pe zyada paise kharch ho gaye aur kahin pe paise kharch nahi hue. So mutual adjustment hai yahan pe. Motion kaise pass hota hai? Why it is called as token grant? 1 rupee is transferred from head A to head B. That's why it is called as token. 1 rupee is transferred from head A to head B. So wo 1 rupee ek symbolic hai. Jitna money chahiye utna transfer ho jata hai. It means that you are actually not adding any money. 1 rupees isliye hai ki new grant hi nahi hai ye. Ye token hai, matlab 1 rupees matlab nothing new is coming. It is only reappropriating. What is a token cut? Do not get confused. Token cut is Yes, that is a cut which is there for cutting. Yes, that is about symbolic cut. Symbolic cut for the reduction of demand for grant. That is a symbolic in nature. 100 rupees matlab koish nahi hai wo. But word same hai. Ye token grant hai, wo token cut hai. Policy cut, economic cut and etc. Now come to the last. That is a rule of lapse and march rush. Rule of lapse and march rush. What is the rule of lapse? See, the thing is that aapne jo money different heads ke liye diya hai. Say for example, NRHM ke liye 500 crore has been granted for one full year. From the March till the, sorry, from the April 1 to the March 30th. NRHM ke liye. Pata chala ki January tak NRHM ne kuch money nahi spend kiya. To iske under hai ki aise nahi hai ki aap is saal money nahi spend kiye to aapka money accumulate ho jayega. So that you can use again for the next month. So, jo, jitna money aapko approve kiya hai, say 500 crore approve kiya tha, you have spent only 400. 100 crore is remaining with you. So, 100 crore wapas jama ho jayega. Next year aapka approval ho jayega, lekin 100 years will go back. Now, naturally, no ministry would like to give back the money. So, jaise hi month of March aa jata hai, to there is a March rush ki isme laga do, usme laga do, kahin pe matlab mosquito ke liye ye kar diya humne, uske liye ye kiya, Egypt ke liye aise kiya, uske liye aisa kiya, SARS ke liye aise kuch na kuch head dikha ke money wo spend kar do. That is called as March rush. March rush is because the money that is remaining will go back into the consolidation fund of India if you will not spend for the purpose it has been designated. To aise hi bekar mein matlab kuch ground mein nahi hai, white corruption. Naam wahin pe dal do legal ki iske liye itna itna wo hai, contraceptive ke liye itna itna, kuch nahi hai wo. The money is, yes, that is called as March rush. Sorry, lapse, rule of lapse is the money which is not spent get lapsed, and since the money will get lapsed, the unused money will get lapsed, nobody wish to, so therefore there is a March rush. Understood? So these are the some of the terms. These are some yahan pe vote on account, vote on credit ek do jyada important hai. Aise hi wo yaad rakho. Terms se yaad rakho. Do not just like try to mug it up. If you remember, supplementary is supplement which is already existing. Additional is a new thing. Excess is excess has already spent. Vote on account to aise bhi yaad hi rakhna hai. Credit is credit for unpredictable and indefinite characters. Special is exceptional is for the special. Token is reappropriation. Rule of lapse is if you don't spend money in given time, it will get lapsed and the money will go back to the consolidation fund. Since you don't wish to, there is always a march rush. Again, that's also a very undemocratic and this thing. That gives rise to the where you can say that yes, inefficiency and corruption and etc. So these are the things. Now last, in 5 minutes we'll see the three funds, consolidation fund and this thing, 5 minutes. Question, in fact all polity question maximum are asked from today's lecture only. These are one of the area which is slightly complex and many a times question comes from this. Yes, different funds of government. First is consolidation fund of India. Consolidation fund of India. What is the article? 266. I'll come later detail. Second is public account of India. Public account of India. Article 266. So difference kya hai? And third is contingency fund of India. What is article now? 3? Yes, article 267. Again, this is one area questions are time and again asked. Okay. Consolidation fund, public account. Okay, in dono ka article same hai. Okay, just clause is different. Okay, clause 1 and clause 2. In fact, if you can remember, aise bhi remember kar sakte ho, 266. One mein dono hai, consolidation fund of India and state. State ke bhi consolidation fund rehte hai, uska article alag nahi hai. Okay, it's 266.1 only. 266.2 mein both the things, consolidation fund of India and public account of India and public account of state. So both 266 ke under. 267 ke under, 267 clause 1 is contingency fund of India and clause 2 is contingency fund of state. ओके याद रखना है तो रखो नहीं तो बाउंसर चला गया तो इसमें स्टेट ऐड करो हियर स्टेट और इसके लिए अलग क्लॉज है डोंट इसके चक्कर में ये मत भूल जाओ ठीक है दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट कंसोलिडेशन फंड ऑफ इंडिया सिंपल इसमें अगर स्टेट यहां पे ऐड कर दो वहां पे स्टेट ऐड कर दो और वहां पे क्लॉज अलग लिखना है now 266, when we say about Consolidation Fund of India, it's the most important fund, jo bhi, matlab unless stated otherwise, okay, is fund mein kya kya jama hota hai, jo bhi abhi tak jo hum bol rahe wo yahi hai. When we are referring to something, budget and this thing, fund mein, from where the money comes, tax and borrowing, that is proposed tax and the borrowing, the fund comes and everything that is being spent out of the Consolidation Fund of India, that is withdrawal. Now here the question they ask is, first of all, one is the article and second is, who is the authority to spend the money? Kiski authority hai? Har koi alag. Isme kiski authority hai? Parliament, abhi bataya tha. Kya likha tha wahan pe, wo statement. No money can be withdrawn out of the Consolidation Fund of India except by law. What is the law mean? That is a parliament. Okay. So, withdrawal authority to spend is by parliament. Parliament obviously in case of, if Consolidation Fund of India and if it is a state, then state legislature. So remember that the CFI's disposal is not with the executive authority. It is with the parliamentary approval. It's a must know article. Okay, that is parliament. And isi ye likha hai, that is you cannot remove the money out of Consolidation Fund of India except by a parliament. Isiliye hame appropriation bill lana padta hai every year. Okay, that is the rationale behind why at all we bring the appropriation bill. Otherwise, demand grant ho gayi to, ultimately executive will start removing the money out of consolidation fund. But no, parliament has to approve this. Now, second, isme kaun sa money aata hai? Ek to article, ye question important hai. What it constitute and who, which is the authority. So, 3 points mein yaad rakho. What is the article? What is it constitutes? And which is the authority for spending. What it constitutes, to samajh mein hai, tax, borrowing and money withdrawal for the government expenditure. Withdrawal for government expenditure. Now, what it constitutes? Public account. So the name itself is suggestive of public account. Matlab public ka money hai ye. Okay, so whatever you deposit, okay, government ko, to government ko daan nahi dete ho, thoda rakhne ke liye, so that there is a liability on the government is to give back. So ownership of money is yours. Okay, when you give in the bank, bank will return you whenever you required. So all the money which is there, it's government is only custody of it. They cannot, there is a liability to give it back whenever the public will ask for it. Here, unki ownership hai, unko spend karna hai kisi ke upar bhi. Here, there is a no liability to pay back to the government. So it's like they are acting like a bank. When we call public account of India, they are only acting like a bank. That is, for some period, they are keeping with themselves. And whenever the public will want, it will be given back. Understood this part? So public account of India mein, all kinds of deposits that public keep with the government, in the form of private fund, provident fund, small savings, banking deposits, jo bhi bank deposits hai, apne bank deposits, post office deposits, insurance. So, jitne bhi aapke scheme hai jisme fund aap jama karte ho, small saving fund, bank deposit, post office deposit, private fund. Okay, these fund are liable. Ye government matlab bhag nahi ja sakta, inko kabhi na kabhi to wapas dene. So in a way, there is a liability on the government to repay back this fund. So it is keeping it only for the temporary period of time. So you should understand ki iska composition aur iska aur nature mein kya farak hai. Authority for spending is with the executives. Okay. Authority for spending lies with executives. Ab spend kyun kar rahe hai wo mat puchho, agar wapas dena hai to bank spend, so obviously they will earn something out of it or ek minimum maintain karenge, wo kabhi na kabhi wapas diya jayega. Okay, so the authority here is of parliament, here the authority is of executive. Now come to this contingency fund of India. Contingency fund, see, the thing is that new fund does not come. Okay, it's only the some fund is earmarked as a contingency fund. Jo bhi wahan ka fund rehta hai, consolidation fund ka, time and again is fund ko separate kiya gaya hai. In fact, the constitution speaks as article 266. Constitution kya bolta hai? Constitution writes, parliament should, parliament by law should create contingency fund. So constitution mein contingency fund likha nahi gaya hai waise. Contingency mein ye likha gaya hai ki parliament should make contingency fund of India. So in this regard, parliament has taken the action and there is a contingency fund of India Act 1950. Parliament ne pass kiya gaya. Something like if you know about resolution of water disputes. Kitna article hai? 262. So 262 mein kya likha hai ki parliament may create the law. So parliament has created the law, that is a water dispute act, through which they have created the judiciary, that is a tribunal system. So constitution mein nahi likha na tha, constitution has left it to the wisdom of the parliament to come up with some law. So it is something like that. The constitution has, the article 267 reads that parliament should come up with something called as contingency fund of India. So contingency fund of India 1950 act pass ho gaya, which has now created the contingency fund of India. So time and time isme paise aa jate hain, matlab earmark ho jate hain. Okay, this is particularly for the disaster management. Okay, contingency, as the name is suggestive of, it is for the disaster management, and X money is retained. Now isme kaun se question puche jate hain, that is who holds this money? Okay, it is being held in the name of president. Okay, in the name of president, but ultimately is de facto finance secretary on behalf of president. Okay, ye rehta hai finance secretary ke paas mein, but generally it is president. Matlab, this is the president authority. In fact, ye aayenge hum. Spend karna hai isse money. Spend karne ke liye kiski authority hai yahan pe? Executive. Okay? Remember, this is again executive. Iska baad mein spend karne ke baad parliament gives the approval to it. But disposal of contingency fund is by the authority of president. So remember, consolidation fund is parliament, public account is executive, and contingency fund is also executive. Okay? On behalf of president, it is being kept by the finance secretary. Wo ek word yaad rakho, okay? Finance secretary yaad kar. But spending is executive. Is there any confusion? Matlab kuch question hai kya? Confusion to hai, obviously, but you have to remember. But the point is, these are again the fund which are time and being asked. Okay? So we will stop here. Aapka questions kal kar lete hai. Theek hai? Yes, any question? Madam, koi question hai kya online ka? Nahi, theek hai? I hope I have not deterred them. Theek hai? If anybody has any doubt or any question, okay, you can meet. Tomorrow, come prepared mentally. Ki exam, matlab mini exam rahegi, parliament and state legislature. Yes. Today we have taken a lot of time because this was required to be discussed. Agar main ye qualification bhi aise likh ke discuss karunga to matlab bahut hi peeche reh jayenge. To wo jo qualification, election vagera padh ke aao. I'll just discuss hurriedly. Then we'll move to the rest of the jaise hai ki dissolution of parliament and there are various procedures, no confidence motion, etc., etc. These things are required. And then we will do the state legislature and comparative analysis. So tomorrow there will be a exam for the parliament and on the state legislature. Okay? Kaun sa president? President chapter? Haan, executive mein dekhenge na. President to executive mein. President mat padh ke aao. Parliament and state legislature. Then we will start executive. Then we will do center-state relation. Then we will do panchayat. And then we will do high court, supreme court. ठीक है, constitutional, non-constitutional bodies, you have to read it. ठीक है, thank you so much.